the first top 10 matchup of the season.
Oregon, Michigan State, tonight at 8 Eastern on ABC.
You're watching the ACC on ESPN. And today from Memorial Stadium in Clemson, South Carolina, the Appalachian State Mountaineers take on the 12th-ranked Clemson Tigers.
Hi, everybody. I'm Joel Myers alongside Coach Tom O'Brien. And welcome to Death Valley. Well, last week, Coach, Clemson took care of Wofford right here in their home opener. Now a quality opponent in Appalachian State, but a short work week on Thursday night right here on ESPN, a road game at Louisville. So the real challenge now for Dabo Swinney and his staff, how do they stay focused on the matter at hand right in front of them with Appalachian State?
Well, his biggest concern is he has 12 seniors, but he has 28 freshmen who he's going to play today. You figure those freshmen were 10 years old when the Mountaineers went into the Big House and upset Michigan that night. So I think that his whole thing has been focus this week. The problem is with those kids is they only get them 4 hours a day. So they may be hearing all week about Louisville. They may be hearing about Notre Dame. So it's going to be interesting how they start the game today.
Exceptional quarterback working for the Clemson Tigers like we saw last year. Deshaun Watson coming off the ACL, but you couldn't tell in the opener, Coach.
No, he's very efficient. 18 of 22 throwing, no sacks, no tackles for loss. Took off, scrambled a couple times, and second time he took off and scrambled, he took a pretty good hit. Great sigh of relief went up from the stadium when he jumped up and got back to the huddle. So I think everybody thinks that he's back, and look forward to watching him in person today.
And a very efficient quarterback as well for Appalachian State in Taylor Lamb, a guy who does everything really well across the board, Coach.
Yeah, and just like Deshaun, he is a sophomore, played last year as a true freshman, came in and started their six-game winning streak. So he did a great job last year coming into this year. He's got some ties to Clemson. His dad's a coach up at Mercer. So he's not going to be flustered being in this atmosphere.
Appalachian State trying to play the role of the spoiler like they did in 2007 at Michigan. Will it happen once again? Can Clemson avoid the upset? We'll find out over the next 3.5 hours. Stay with us in Death Valley. Welcome back once again to one of the best settings in all of college football. This is the ACC on ESPN, and there is nothing quite like Death Valley. We saw him touch the rock that was given to Clemson many years ago by a Clemson alum, but it was taken from Death Valley, California to Death Valley, Clemson, South Carolina. Coach, you've done it a lot. You've been here many times. It's a pretty special place.
It's one of the great atmospheres in college football, one of the great venues here in the ACC. This App State team looks ready to go. They came.
Let's put 15 minutes on the game clock.
App State team came out with 5 minutes and 37 seconds on the game clock. I don't know anybody that comes out that early. So we'll see if they are ready to play.
App State's going to receive as Bobo Beathard is going to be back along with Jaquill Capel. So Clemson won the toss, deferred their option to the second half, and Ugo gets into it, and we are underway. Good to have you with us. Over to the far side, it's going to be Capel inside his own 10. Nice lane over to the right side. Good return down the sideline, and he's out of bounds. Out of bounds past the 40, bumped out barely, and what a return. So Jaquill Capel, a junior from Mount Gilead, North Carolina. Serious seam, and boy, did he follow the block. Out of bounds, unfortunately, for App State, but Coach, great field position. You're on the road. You might have jitters. Well, got rid of them in a hurry.
No, that helps a lot. They did a great job trapping out number one and two on the kickoff coverage there, and he went right up the seam.
The quarterback, Taylor Lamb, the Sun Belt Conference Freshman of the Year last season. Had almost a 400-yard passing game. Man, we're going to get a dead ball foul right away on a false start. And that's where it begins.
Yeah, this is something that
prior to the ball being snapped, full start, 79, offense, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
So right away, going the other way, and we talked about Taylor Lamb. This is a third-year sophomore, 6'2", 200-pound from Calhoun, Georgia. He started 10 games as a freshman last season. Comes in.
Please Jordan. Reset the game clock to 14:53.
We will. So six more seconds on the clock. He broke all their freshman records, throwing for 2,400 yards, 17 scores. And he also can run, Coach, 500 yards and four touchdowns as well on the ground.
Yeah, he has good elusive ability. He'll get out of the pocket if he has a chance to run. Now, this is not exactly what Coach Satterfield wanted. The one thing he told us is you want to be very good on first down. But you don't want to be behind the chains against this Clemson football team because this is what Coach Venables wants.
Two on the wide side of the field. Man, it's going to be Cox out of the backfield. Forget about it. Lost a yard. Good play. Ripping him down, Shaq Lawson. Their big rush end on the right side, the junior from Central South Carolina. And our impact players, Shaq Lawson.
Shaq Lawson on the defense for Clemson. He's defensive end. They think really good things at with him, and they're looking for this situation. They want to put him in a pass rush situation, and they get one now.
So Shaq Lawson, he's played in every game since he arrived at Clemson. Man, a little waggle action on the misdirection and on the deflection. It's incomplete. In the neighborhood of McElfresh, former walk-on downfield, the senior from Charlotte.
Good play by the safety, Javon Curse. He read the booth, came, undercut it, almost got himself an interception.
Safety Curse, the junior from Fort Myers, Florida, and the nephew of the man they used to call the freak, Javon Curse. Well, the Florida All-American. So now, third and long. It'll be third and 16. Working out of the gun with Trips on the wide side of the field. On a little stop route, Malachi Jones can't get to the first down. Made the first man miss as he gets to the midfield stripe. Bumped out of bounds. Jones, the senior from Roswell, Georgia, so at least some of the penalty yardage and some yardage back for the punt.
Did a nice job picking up the blitz on this, giving the quarterback Lamb time to stand in there. This is what I asked him. He had a chance to go for it some on fourth down. He said he did in his own territory last week at Howard game and made it. Well, anything less than 3 yards.
And what about the H-back, Coach? He's on the right side, Burns. Let's see if he's involved. It's almost like an offset eye.
Oh, no, they're going to.
Now they're,
yeah.
Pooch punt from the quarterback, Lamb.
Got to get a roll.
And not much of a roll inside the 30. So instead of a regular punt and putting them potentially down deep in their own territory, Clemson will take it all the way at their own 26. So a break for the Tigers.
Yeah, that false start penalty. You know, just a little bit anxious up there on the front line, trying to get going and get the game underway to hit somebody. That's the way those offensive linemen think.
You coached here a lot, haven't you?
Yes, I have.
You try to get your team settled down early, don't you?
Yeah, you try to. But these kids are excited, and, you know, that's a good thing. Now, here we come, speedball.
The sophomore from Gainesville, Georgia, Deshaun Watson. Now, what a gifted athlete. Big hole, breaking through. It's Gallman. And as you mentioned, Coach, and we look at the impact players, all their running backs are at least 200 pounds at Clemson.
Yeah, he's a big back. He went through a tackle on this one, so broke a tackle and kept running. They're going to have trouble getting these guys on the ground. They're going to have to do it for any good.
Watson, we've talked about Ronald Blair, the defensive end, who led App State in sacks last year. And a little flip on the outside. It should be enough for the first down, going to Artavis Scott, a sophomore from Clearwater. He had some cushion on the outside, and they'll move the chains up to the 37.
Well, Clemson got into a two tight end formation, which allowed them to get the flat open and took the flat, took what the defense gave them.
Four-man front. Gallman trying to turn the corner. And good lateral pursuits.
Very good run.
Dropping for a 2-yard loss.
Very good. And that's, you know.
You said it when they came out, they look comfortable. That's John Law in the middle of things.
Right. Here's the thing, you got to get lined up against this offense. I mean, that's Coach Woody's biggest concern right now. They go fast.
It's second and just about 12. They've got an athlete, a quarterback who can run. He'll throw, and it's intercepted. picked off. Great play. What a grab by Gibbs. What a way to begin for Appalachian State, the sophomore from Kennesaw, Georgia.
Great play. Anticipated the throw, tried to throw a slant in there, was a little bit in front of him and made the play.
Boy, if they needed a confidence boost early, they just got one, Tom.
Yeah, they did. Back to almost where they started.
So an early takeaway for Appalachian State on the road, and they've got it for the second consecutive time in great field position. Clemson coming off a convincing win last week. Now how do they deal with adversity? The interception, first of the year, given up by Watson.
Well, Coach Satterfield told us he's going to use some formations. First down last time he was unbalanced. They're an unbalanced line here. Clemson was practicing this yesterday at practice. They have a check for this.
Sending Campbell in motion. Van Cox on the misdirection. Nothing doing. Another loss. Clemson was exceptional. Number one in total defense to begin with last year. And, Coach, they were phenomenal in the opener against the run.
Yeah, they were, especially against the Wofford, who runs a triple option, to do what they did last week to the triple option. So whole thing is to stop and run. The offense wants to run the football and not having much success right now.
You just saw Travis Blanks. We'll get into his story, the junior from Tallahassee. Now, what a story it is. Cox trying to get back the original line. Got a couple. It'll be third and long once again, but back to Travis Blanks. Two ACLs later, and as Dabo Swinney told us yesterday, great person, great mindset, and one of the most motivated guys he's ever been around.
Well, you know, if you come back after two ACLs, you're just so happy to be out there and play. You know, I'm really happy that he's been able to get out here and play.
It's going to be third and long. Second consecutive series with great field position for App State. Pocket collapsing and going for the deep ball and overshooting. Shannon Metters, the sophomore from Duncan, South Carolina. So once again, and it collapsed late, but still ample time in the pocket, Coach. They can't take advantage of great field position.
Yeah, they did. And one thing that Lamb is doing, he's catching the ball and he's getting rid of it. He's not holding it long enough. They had a chance to get to him that time, but got rid of it. And it's nice to have a 6'5" safety in Kirsten again to come over the top and almost get a piece of that ball again.
Artavis Scott waits back deep for the punt, the sophomore from Clearwater, as Bentley Critcher will get into it. No pressure on the punter. High one, short one, and a clean, fair catch called for and taken in by Scott. So Clemson will get it back deep in their own territory at the 20.
That was one of the things Danny Pierman, the special teams coach at Clemson, was worried about. Not a lot of punts last week. You know, he had some right. things on tape that they weren't sure of. They have a new coach this year. Stu Holt came over. He had some special team experience, Coach Satterfield told us. So, you know, their special teams, Clemson, is going to be sound today early until they figure out what's going on.
Watch it.
Here we go.
He'll run it himself after he buried it in the play fake with Goldman. We talked about his athleticism. Watson, by the way, was 18 of 22 passing last week as Blair put him down for 194 yards with a couple of scores. So, as we said, an early pick. Get that out of the way, the mistake. Didn't carry it all that often, but did take that pop you talked about at the top of the telecast. It'll be Goldman. He's got room, and he's got a first down across the, let's see where they know. Originally they put the linesman came up across the 30 and then he came back. It's going to be third and less than a yard.
You know, I think Coach Sweeney told us the word he used for him was physical. He looked up that safety to run into. But they did a great job of standing it up and keeping him. Oh, they gave him the first down. So
yeah, put it right on the nose. But right. As you said, Coach Sweeney told us yesterday, he doesn't mind violent collisions.
No, he doesn't.
Goldman. 6'1", 215-pounder. Little throw and a low throw, and nowhere near Sharon Peake.
No.
Another guy that has graduated. They've got 8 graduates on this team.
Yeah, they've done a great job graduating people. They've been in the top 10 in their APR here the last 3 years, which is a great tribute to this coaching staff at Clemson University.
Yeah, Coach Sweeney mentioned it, and what a job he has done. He said he's had 120 seniors and 114 have graduated. And some of the other 6 in the NFL still coming back. It's complete. Little dart, and it's a first down to Peake. That's a guy that's been injured most of the last 2 years. 49 career catches coming into the new season. Big receiver.
Yeah, and he's had to take Mike Williams' place as a split end. And, you know, interesting to say Coach Sweeney said he's the second fastest guy he's coached behind Kobe Ford, who was a track star here. There you go.
Interesting formation. Double move, a little stiff arm. A flag on the play. It looked like Scott was putting the arm out to try to separate himself, but let's see if he's being held.
Yeah, it's offensive interference.
Yep.
What they've done is now they've gotten in that two tight end single back
pass
look twice and thrown out.
Offense.
Now they went with the out and up
penalty
for the big one and ended up with the hand push.
Good read. Mondo Williams, the defensive back, was working, the junior from Iowa City. And he's come in, and he has contributed right away for App State.
Yeah, this is a big penalty. And the offensive pass interference is very punitive. Now they're
Well, even when they had, as we look at the drives for Watson last week, Coach, even when they had 11 and 10 and 12 play drives, they were fast.
No. They went 18 seconds average, and that was a fast one because he wasn't ready for the ball.
It's a short gain on the run.
Lucky they got that one back.
Yeah, talk about quick. Is he ready? Gallman's in the backfield.
He's looking to his right, and all the ball hits him.
That's a lucky one. Softly off his leg.
Yeah.
Second and long. Low snap this time, and a hot one. And on the out, wide open. It's complete. And when he get it, he's right at the first down, Artavis Scott.
Happy State is concerned about getting beat deep. That's one of the things they were concerned about here. And they're giving him a chance to throw the ball in the flats.
Good pocket protection. They'll move the chains. It's a first down on a drive that started back at the Clemson 20. Seam is available, and it's complete. Another first down. This time it goes to Jermon Hopper, a junior from Charlotte.
Good play call there. You know, last week they scored on that play on a touchdown, threw it to the flat and scored on a touchdown. But this one today, you know, it was a good job by Tony Elliott calling that. Fake the throw, the flat, went deep.
Flag on the play.
I think the freshman left tackle, 75, jumped early.
Full start, number 75, offense, 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
Good call, Coach. And Mitch Hyatt is the first true freshman to start on the offensive line at Clemson since 1944.
Yeah, they asked him last week if he was nervous to be starting. He goes, the most nervous thing I did was run down that hill. I didn't want to fall down. I don't care about the game. I think I'm with him.
Just about 7 minutes into the contest. Scott on the little flip. And that was, it looked like he wanted to throw the football. He's going to be dropped for a big loss. Coach, it looked like a gadget play.
No, that's the speed sweep. That's you saw that a couple years. West Virginia used it in the bowl game. It's an underhand flip, and he takes off and runs. Penetration kills it, which is what happened on that play.
Exceptional play by the linebacker. Weaving his way inside the 35 is Gallman on second. They need to go close to the 11 for a first down. So already in field goal territory.
Yeah, well, they didn't kick a field goal last week. They have a brand new field goal kicker here. So now decision, do you play for a field goal or go for the first down? He told me that, what he tells us, 52, 53 yards.
Yes.
They're within field goal range right now.
Great pocket protection, ton of time, and over his shoots. A vulnerable wide receiver. As it was right through the hands of Peak.
Right. You know, he'll get better at that throw.
Yeah, the first career try for Greg Hugel, a redshirt freshman from Blythewood, South Carolina. He is going to be just a 49 attempt. Not a bad way to be indoctrinated. So let's see if he can get Clemson an early lead. He pushed it. Will he be able to bring it in? With a flag down on the play, it is wide right.
I think he's going to get another chance here.
Yes. Offside.
Offside. Number five. Defense. 5-yard penalty. Repeat fourth down.
Good piece of coaching there. Coach Sweeney went out and said to him, come on, son, I know you can make this kick. Just keep your head down and follow through.
Right.
Just like a golf swing.
A little confidence.
Keep your head down and follow through.
And the holder for him, number 85, sophomore from Summit, New Jersey, is Seth Ryan. Football family, I guess.
Yes.
Buddy Ryan's grandson, head coach of the Buffalo Bills, Rex Ryan's son.
Absolutely.
So it's going to be a 44-yard attempt. Another try for Hugel. And another flag. And the same result because he pushed it. I mean, even if it
get him to another hash. You can't do that.
Prior to the snap, offside, number 36. Defense with contact, 5-yard penalty. Repeat fourth down.
What a break.
No, they don't. Keeping themselves on the field longer. They need to get off the field.
Mistakes for Appalachian State. Right. And now a very manageable one, a 39-yard attempt. Now, where's that hook when you need it?
I don't know.
I got a duck hook, but he doesn't need that.
You think Seth Ryan takes control of that huddle?
Will the third try be a charm for Greg Hugel?
Yep.
He's got it. So Appalachian State certainly helped the Clemson Tigers during that sequence. So Hugel, his first career field goal, and Clemson's up by 3. We welcome you back once again to Death Valley. Clemson fortunate to have 3 points on their third try after 2 Markoffs against Appalachian State. Joel Myers along with Coach Tom O'Brien. Coach, you've had some wins here in Death Valley.
Yeah, we had at Boston College, and actually the first time we came down here. Our inaugural, I think it was our inaugural year in the ACC. Won in overtime on a hot, muggy day. I mean, we're fortunate today that we've got overcast skies. And Appalachian State, I know, is very happy with this. They spent a lot of extra time working out in the afternoon. They were afraid of the heat here. You look, they spent a lot of time on the field, especially on defense. The offense has got to get some first downs and help that defense out.
Kicked away by Hugel. Man, it's going to be
same return.
Cable and a nice return over to the right side. Same return as you mentioned, yeah. Coach. Out across the 35. They'll put him at the 36. So Appalachian State has started now their own 43-46. And this third time at the 36. You know, you're living large with field position like that. You got to capitalize.
Absolutely. First down. They got to win first down. 2 first downs they've had, they've lost yardage. So see what Coach Satterfield dials up here.
Marcus Cox staying in the backfield. Had a good thing going at Appalachian State. They've got a former Mountaineer as their head coach. We'll talk about Dabo Swinney and the run of the momentum for the Clemson program. Plenty of time for Lamb. And through the progression read, Coach, it looked like he checked down to his running back, Marcus Cox.
Yeah, the guy that he made a good play fake to. He snuck out of the line. No blitz by Clemson that time. Didn't have any pickup. Other receivers, and that's what a smart quarterback does. That's what a coach's son does. He'll dump the ball off and try not to make something out of nothing.
Taylor Lamb starting 10 games as a freshman last season. Looks at a 2nd and 4. Cox looking for something over to the right side. Forget it. And we talked about this Clemson run defense as there was no gain. It was Christian Wilkinson on that stop. This Clemson defense, and you said it, Wofford, a triple option team that averaged 297 yards a game on the ground last year. They were held to 123 by the Clemson front.
Yeah, this is their concern. They only have 3 starters back on defense. Now, yesterday walking a walkthrough, all Coach Sweeney could talk about was Christian Wilkins, who made that play. Said he's a freak of nature.
So what are the linemen? And that is moving over Parker Collins, the junior for North Augusta, South Carolina. He's an honorable mention all Sun Belt Conference guy last year. Looks like he got a little nicked up.
Yeah, he's their, you know, coach told us he's their most physical player. He's the guy that he thinks is their best guy, so they got to get him back in the game.
Will it be 3 and out for the 3rd consecutive time for Appalachian State? They show the blitz.
Pressure.
Yep. And should have been picked. It is dropped in the secondary. It was T.J. Green, and he couldn't believe what was in front of him.
Yeah, he had a chance there, but once again, Taylor's got to get the ball, He's got to get rid of the ball. He got rid of the ball, and the route didn't match up with the speed which he has to throw. Now, here's something, you know, a freshman. They have a true freshman snapper who didn't snap the one time last week on a punt. So here he is in Death Valley. No, they didn't punt. That's right. So he's snapping for the second time.
Scott is back. You're talking about Elias McMurray.
Yeah.
And that is a really good punt, keeping it away as it goes out of bounds. Let's see where they mark it. The punt by Bentley Critcher. So once again, Clemson has it deep in their own territory, though. They'll have it back at their own 23, up by 3. $81,500 every Saturday they are at home. What a luxury. Coach Tom O'Brien, one of the great atmospheres, and you mentioned when we were up at the booth earlier, what is this, you know, in the last 40 years, your third time in a stadium where you haven't been on the sideline?
It's hard to believe.
It's different, isn't it?
It's different.
Well, we're fortunate to have you with us as we continue with the ACC on ESPN. Clemson's got a first and 10 at their own 23. 79 total yards and only 19. And Gallman with a little jump cut gets it up for about 6 to the 29-yard line. Big back, but still showed the good feet.
Gilchrist is the big guy on defense for App State. He's got to make a lot of plays.
That is Keenan Gilchrist, the outside backer, who's in on that. And on the run, good throw, great catch. Take it in by Hunter Renfro. That's his first catch of the game. The redshirt freshman from Myrtle Beach. You talked about it. They could play 28 freshmen, true and redshirt today. 27 last week.
Well, mix up personnel here slows them down a little bit.
Sixth first down for Clemson. None yet over the first 10 minutes of the game for App State. And away from Watson. Look out. Gilchrist was all over it. And Deshaun Watson was fortunate to cover that.
He's okay here. He took a big hit.
On the shoulder?
Yeah, when he was down the ground. Trying to recover the ball. This is how quarterbacks get hurt more than any time.
And a vulnerable spot. Keenan Gilchrist, honorable mention all Sun Belt Conference last year. As you mentioned, very quick.
Right.
And they are still, unfortunately, looking at Deshaun Watson, the sophomore from Gainesville, Georgia.
Certainly a hush has come over the stadium here now. And hopefully he's going to be able to get up and resume play.
He was vulnerable.
It's been a tough year so far for quarterbacks.
Schuessler warming up, the junior backup, a former walk-on. Schuessler at 6'3", 200 pounds.
And then they have another dynamic freshman in Kelly Bryant that played some last Saturday. They got all three quarterbacks in. So if there was a silver line last week, is that they got three quarterbacks repetitions.
Tom, if things changed in a coach's mindset, we talk about 28 freshmen being used by Dabo Swinney, that a lot of these kids, especially the skill kids, if they're that good, they're going to be gone after 3 years?
Well, I think so, absolutely. Plus, it's easier to play as a freshman. You know, it's unusual for a guy like Hyatt to be playing at left tackle. I mean, that's really rare. And that just shows you what his abilities are. But if you're a wide receiver, you're a running back, you're a defensive back, linebacker, you generally can get on the field if you have the skills and ability to play that position.
Talking about Mitch Hyatt, true freshman, starts at left tackle at 6'5", 295. So Watson out for at least this snap. Nick Schuessler is taking over. Guy that originally signed at Mississippi State. And on the
nice
delay.
Safe play, called a draw play, got the ball. They are what they are, the fans going. But, hey, he got the snap and handed the ball off.
Oluwale Dada with a sensational play underneath, the junior from Columbus, Georgia. And now Watson right back into the lineup. Good news.
Absolutely.
But after the bad snap, and we've seen three errant snaps already in this game. Two that Watson cleaned up for the snapper. For his center, Ryan Norton. Screen, little bubble action.
Great play.
Gilchrist again.
Great
time play.
Good read, good play.
How about that read and recovery?
He's the outside linebacker covering down there and sees he's got two outside, gets outside and makes a play.
Back deep. It is going to be Bobo Beathard, another guy from a football family playing for App State. So
he's got ability to go all the way. So let's see if they punt to him and give him the chance to return.
Good punt.
Great punt.
Critcher gets into it. Or check that. Teasdall gets into it. Beathard, though, makes a good move originally, but yeah, the outside containment was there, and he's down at the 30. So App State with their worst field position. I said a football family. His dad is a scout for the Carolina Panthers. His granddad, what a general manager he was in the NFL, Bobby Beathard.
Bobby Beathard?
Yep. Washington Redskins, San Diego Chargers. He grew up in the game. So now Taylor Lamb. All right, you're on the road, 81,500. One of the toughest environments to play in. Maybe things have settled down, Coach. They haven't had a first down yet.
No, they need to get a first down.
A little misdirection.
Kind of a little misdirection.
And can't get out of the backfield.
Can't get off.
Exceptional play underneath. It was Christian Wilkins, a true freshman from Springfield, Massachusetts. This guy was rated the fourth best defensive tackle in high school football in the country last year.
He thinks he's an exceptional football player. Trying another double move.
And
you're going to get an interference call. I believe he got pushed.
There was contact. Tankersley defending on the play. So they went for Metters. And was it catchable?
Pass interference, number 25, defense, 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
That's Cordrea Tankersley, a junior from Beach Island, South Carolina.
Contact right there. It looks like they got Parker Collins back in there, so he was able to get back in the lineup.
That's big. Their left guard back into the lineup. First down, and the first down of the game comes by way of penalty and a big hole over to the right side. That is Terrence Upshaw, the backup, the sophomore from Duluth, Georgia. And one of their best runs so far, a gain of five.
Spent a lot of time running to the right, or is that just me?
No, that's
like
not just you.
Just taking off and heading to the right.
Even when they're working.
That's a good start for first down.
Even when they're working counters, it's going back that way to their own boundary. Second and five.
Double screen
yep,
here.
Yep, and you got
great setup.
And it's beautiful setup to Upshaw into the secondary. And he's got a first down inside the 25.
And you got two Clemson players down.
As you mentioned, Bulware, the weak side backer, is down. And so is Shaq Lawson, the defensive end.
Shaq Lawson's one of our impact players.
Boy, it's a friendly fire.
Yeah.
His own man onto the collision course for Shaq Lawson. But as you said, the design of the deception of that play call.
Very good. Get a lot of pressure on the quarterback. That's one way to slow the rush down. Screens and draws.
So they took each other out. Unfortunately, Bulware tried to track and recover. And Shaq Lawson. So Lawson over to the sideline. And all of a sudden, from the Appalachian State 30, quickly, they're down to the Clemson 24, looking to take the lead. Final 2:05 and counting. Left in the opening 15 minutes of play. So, coach's son, Taylor Lamb. His father, Bobby, a quarterback at Furman in his playing days. And he also coached the Paladins for nine years.
Yes, he did. Excellent coach. He's at Mercer now.
Little jet sweep.
Look out.
And what a job by Taylor Lamb to get away from Bulware. And now into the corner of the end zone. Intercepted. Hurst comes up with a pick.
Third time's the charm for Kearse. Got his ball, got his hand on two balls earlier, was able to make the interception, undercut it there.
So the opportunity goes away by the takeaway. Good coverage.
Great coverage. Great job.
Trying to hit.
Then it helps to be 6'5 and run. I mean, you look at those safeties they have.
6'3", T.J. Green, 6'5", Jaron Curse.
I got some big boys back there. Great-looking athletes. All right, now it's on App State's defense. Got to hang in there. Get to the end of the quarter.
Out of the spin. Slick maneuver. As they're going to use all their backs. And that was C.J. Davidson. A guy right here in Clemson. He's already got a degree in sociology, a former walk-on. Now tempo. Will Clemson find a rhythm offensively? Give App State credit. Real good job early. And off the edge. Watson did not see that coming, did he? And it was the outside when they pinched in particular, Sambo, the outside backer.
You know, the one thing Coach Woody does with this 3-4 defense, he has boundary players and he has field players, so it helps them when they're on the hash to get lined up quicker. When they get to the middle of the field is when they have problems.
So Sambo started it. Fernandez cleaned up. And now third and about four. Ton of time for Watson. He can run for it.
That's where he's dangerous.
And hurdles to the first down.
That's just exceptional athletic ability. They were trying to run a little corner route into the boundary with a stop route below it. Both guys were covered, took off and ran. Look at that athleticism. And fast to the ball.
Stops the clock, movement of the chains, restarts.
Pounding again. Just
keep that's Davidson.
In the middle. You know, that's like a heavyweight fight. Those punches to the midsection don't mean a lot in the first quarter, but by the time you get to third and the fourth, instead of a 3-yard gain, they might be a 10-yard gain.
Work the body, and then they're down for the count later.
That's what power does. That's what that running does. Keep Giannis.
That's the center, by the way, unfortunately, hobbling up.
Yeah.
They got a junior backing him up. So Ryan Norton over at the sideline, and that is going to do it. When they start the clock, let's see. They should run it now. After he gets over to the sideline, that should be the end of the first 15 minutes of play. And they haven't started the clock yet.
No, they won't start until I tell them to go out. You know, but that's one position that you really don't want to lose your center, because he's the captain of the line. He's the only guy besides the quarterback that generally touches the ball every play. And they're in the shotgun. They've had a few errant snaps already. So let's see what's going to happen now, if they're going to let the clock run out and then get some snaps.
Very entertaining start. Dabo Swinney, man is Clemson Tigers. Heavy favorites coming in. Lead by only three. Got the long field goal. Watson's got another first down when we come back. Back once again to Clemson, South Carolina. Joel Myers along with Coach Tom O'Brien. And Watson's going to put it back into play in a hurry with Davidson, the running back, on second and long. He is shut down.
He got a couple yards there, but did some in a manageable third and five on third down.
Guy that ran for the Clemson track team, former walk-on, C.J. Davidson. But now a third and six. Clemson on third down so far, just one of three. So give Appalachian State credit. It started deep in Clemson territory after the pick by Curse at the goal line. Two to each side for Curse, or for Watson. And the underneath pattern will get them the first down. Alert play stretching out. Jordan Leggett, the junior, tied in. He's put down by Howard, the safety.
It came with a zone blitz. Here comes the quick snap and a throw into the boundary.
No chance for personnel moves. It's Scott on the completion, weaving his way for about seven on first down. So Clemson.
Preparing for Clemson, you have to get ready for that play after a first down, especially on their boundary. It's coming. I'm telling you.
And coaches, almost seems like they want to quicken the pace.
Yeah, they do. They want to get things going now. They got to get Appalachian State back on their heels, and that's what they're trying to do, is make them get back on their heels.
Second and three. Davidson shut down, knocked down. And that was Eric Boggs in the middle of things, the inside backer, a sophomore, Belton, South Carolina.
Another third down manageable. They've been getting into the third down and manageable situations for them, or third and three.
So it started back at the 20. And let's see if they try to power it with Davidson. Small guy, but he's a powerful guy, a little over 200 pounds. And he was hit in the backfield.
Yeah,
let's see. Outstanding play again.
See what they're going to do here on fourth down.
Ronald Blair, the end, almost like he was untouched, the senior from Greensboro, Georgia.
I think Coach Sweeney likes what he sees out of his defense, going to choose to punt here. And that was a good job by Guillermo, the backup center. You know, last week, Norton went down, the starter. He's the only returning letterman, or starter, in the offensive line last year. So now two games in a row, he's gone down. So all five guys are new starters this year for Clemson.
Beathard waits for the punt from Teasdall. Another former walk-on here at Clemson. Good hang time last time. Van is going to be Beathard on the short one, calling for the fair catch, and he's got it at the 13. Worst field position to start a drive. Keeps going that way for Appalachian State. They squandered an opportunity. Last possession. See if they can't capitalize this time. Welcome back once again. Appalachian State coming in with a seven-game winning streak, the fifth longest in the nation, and hanging tough against the 12th-ranked Clemson Tigers. As we're just a little more than 2 minutes gone in the second quarter. And their quarterback, don't forget their quarterback, Tanner Lamb, he has connections to Clemson, ties to Clemson way back when. We'll get to that in just a moment. He's got Upshaw in the backfield. Man, tried to buy some time out of the edge, over the head of McElfresh, his intended target. Back to Tanner Lamb. His great-grandfather, in fact, played baseball here at Clemson.
Yeah, he did. He had a little pressure in his face that time. Clemson jumped into the Bear defense, covered everybody up front, was playing run because that's what they're seeing on first down. Pressure off the edge, got a little bit hand in his way, had to throw it over the hand.
It's a different story for the guy that led the Sun Belt in passing efficiency last year. And on second and 10, boy, how about that run defense of Clemson once again? So we talked about it last week. They stopped him. And, Coach, they lost eight starters from this defense, but there's no letdown.
No, there's not. And going to substitution defense here, we'll see what they're going to dial up pressure. Going to an empty backfield. So either the quarterback's running or he's throwing it. Nobody else back there.
Third and 10.
Now, what Coach Venables has is he has a zone check and he probably has a man check. And it looks like they're going to the man check.
5 wide receivers set. Blitz and there an interception. Big man in front, taking it inside the 5 to the 10. Touchdown Clemson. What a moment for Carlos Watkins.
Doesn't get any better than that. Showed blitz. Backed out. Lineman. What he does there is he baits the one lineman to pick him up. And sometimes those defensive linemen read. And the guy who gets blocked backs out of there. The other guy keeps going. He had somebody assigned to him to block. He backed out. Got right in the throw. Tried to throw a quick slant.
So as we talk about losing all starters, this young man is a first-year starter. Big junior from Mooresboro, North Carolina.
Great hands, and he runs well, doesn't he? Don't want to get in his way. Nobody want to tackle him.
Hugel for the point after. And points for the defense as Tanner Lamb is picked for the second time early in this contest. So one of the big guys, a pick six, and Clemson leads by 10. Clemson found the end zone, but it wasn't from an offense that produced 49 points last week on the opening Saturday of the season. It was from their defense. Not exactly a shot. The guy that scored it, though, that is a shot, Carlos Watkins.
Yeah, it wasn't the way it happened, but this is exactly what Coach Venables wanted to have happen. He wanted to get into some third down situations, against somebody that has to throw the ball going forward for the rest of the year. They got Appalachian State in that situation, threw the ball and scored. Now they made two big plays. They've intercepted the ball to stop the Mountaineers from scoring, and then they made a big play themselves and scored a touchdown, and here's the ball back out at the 30-yard line.
Yep, good return by Beathard, as there was a short one. And now Appalachian State is going to have it back at their own 28-yard line. So you see the difference in the two quarterbacks, the two picks, as Lamb is looking for his first completion. So Appalachian State, 50 yards of total offense against one of the best defensive units in the nation. They get it back, though, in solid field position.
This is a key series here for Appalachian State. They need to get a first down.
Hand off. DeMarcus Cox. He's back into the game. The junior from Gakula, Georgia. And it was Goodson in on the stop. The young man that's now seventh on the all-time rushing list for Appalachian State. After he came into the season averaging 111 yards a game. Slow beginning. And another interception. It'll be picked off. And as Bullware, it didn't look like Taylor Lamb ever looked off that one receiver.
No, throwing the inside slant again. And somebody coming from inside to the outside and made the interception. Two plays in a row. He just sat right there, read the quarterback's eyes, stepped right in front of him.
Oh, he was surrounded. So he's trying to get it to Metters. Ben Bullware, the junior from right down the road in Anderson, South Carolina. And Lamb, talk about frustration.
Yeah. He's getting coached up over on the sideline now. Right now, we got a defense has got to make a play.
So that's three consecutive interceptions of Lamb by the Clemson defense. And now, Ken, on a short field, the offense generates something. Gallman stumbles his way for about three inside the 25, down to the 24. So the Clemson offense that did anything they wanted last week, it's a different story so far. Give App State credit. 4 minutes gone by in the second quarter. Short side option.
Wow. Speed option.
And good recovery. And then the penetration by Roderick Byers as well. And Norwood was in there. Or check that, Norwood was in there.
Took away the pitch. Made Watson run the ball.
Torpedoed that play, and now third and long. No gain on the carry. Still at the 24. Four-man front. And a ton of time for Watson. Wide open in the end zone. Touchdown, Clemson. Peak in the corner.
Threw another corner route. Well-timed pass.
24-yard score. Took a while to get there.
Well, you got a big 6'3 receiver back there, too. Goes up and gets the football. Hangs on to it.
So once again, points off a turnover, and you can't have that happen when you're the underdog to begin with in Death Valley.
And you can't do it in your own territory.
Hugo had a good job by the holder.
Dave Clemson, a short field.
So Seth Ryan brought it down on a high snap. Pete gets the 24-yard touchdown throw. It is a 17-0 lead for the 12th-ranked Tigers. Early 17-point lead. The ACC's Clemson Tigers, as the ACC on ESPN continues. The matchup of the Sun Belt and the ACC. And a nightmare of a start for Taylor Lamb. So efficient last year in Sun Belt Conference play, but he's been picked off three times on three consecutive possessions. And it's not like Coach Watson has thrown it down the field all that much, but he has been efficient 10 of 13.
They make him efficient. They give him some good throws. You know, that's a good safe throw for him down there in the red zone. I'm sure they practice that one a lot.
Ugel gets into it. Bathard backpedaling, looking for that lane over to the left side. Man barely makes it back to the 20. He doesn't. He'll be at the 19. But the seventh possession already in the first half with 5 minutes gone to the second quarter for Appalachian State. So let's see how they recover and respond to that kind of adversity, and especially to their quarterback, Taylor Lamb.
Yeah, I expect him to come out, still run the ball here on first down, try to keep pounding away.
I talked about Lamb as great-granddad, who's 94 years old and was going to try to be here today to watch his grandson, who played baseball at Clemson. Took a half hour to get the handoff to Marcus Cox.
Well, that's that little counter play they ran earlier, but this time instead of a base defense, they got pressure off the edge. One too many players falling on the block on that side.
Brett Venables, you said it, the defensive coordinator, came over after a long run with Bob Stoops at Oklahoma. And it had to be a good feeling for him after that bowl game last year, 40-6.
I'm sure it did.
Clemson over the Oklahoma Sooners. It's a loss of three, back at the 16. Lamb in trouble. And it's incomplete. Diving attempt on the pick by Ryan Carter.
I'll tell you what they're doing. They went with a four-man rush that time, but they put the linebacker on Taylor Lamb. They assigned him to him. So as soon as he took off and started to scramble, you see 44 here. He comes out and gets right in his face and makes the play. So that's a good play by Goodson.
A little spy action.
A little spy action by the linebacker.
It'll be third and 13. Will it go from bad to worse? 0 for 4 for App State on their third down conversions. Delay.
Good call.
Cox.
Get back what you can.
Got out to the 18 near the original line of scrimmage, and that'll do it. So Clemson should find themselves in real good shape field position wise as Scott is going to go back for the punt from Pritchard.
Now the key to their special teams this week was cover, cover, cover. Now they've kicked, seemed to kick away from the single safety back here. Let's see if that continues. If they do it, the ball's going to come over here towards the Clemson bench. Kicked it to him.
Right down the middle. Scott's got some room. And won't break away. Good
great,
coverage
great
downfield.
Coverage. Good coverage.
It's at the 36 for Clemson. So six possessions for Clemson, 17 points on the board. This is number six. And Watson took a shot, was shaken up. If you join us a little bit late, but back on the field after missing once now. Some kind of athlete.
Norton's still out. Guillermo's still in. I was watching line coach Robbie Caldwell. He was giving him a little encouragement on the sideline after that last series.
Unfortunately, it's not a true or redshirt freshman.
No.
Guillermo is a junior.
Here we go.
And on the play fake, good move by Watson into the secondary, and then a grill. They grab him by the face mask. Add on 15 from bad to worse for Appalachian State.
Now, the thing is with this young offensive line, they went through the whole camp blocking four down linemen. They're playing a three down lineman team. You know, so they have to get used to the three down linemen, the nose tackle, the two guys. A little different defense than they're used to blocking.
So the penalty, as you saw, on Alex Gray. And Watson was, you saw Watson's hand. His hand was on the face mask of Gray.
Right.
He's trying to stiff arm him. That's tough for the defensive back. First down inside the 42.
A little pressure off the edge of the field.
And almost a phenomenal grab by the tight end.
And how about that? Devin Stringer, high school teammate of Deshaun Watson, made the tackle.
And
best buddies
right.
Through high school, got to make a play on him, bounced up. Didn't say anything, got right back to the line of scrimmage because he know the ball's coming out fast.
And talk about playing with a heavy heart. Oh. Devin Stringer, a child born. His daughter passed away a few days ago, an 11-year-old baby girl. So our thoughts are with that young man and his entire family.
11-day-old.
Yes.
11-day-old, yes.
Little out. Man, it's complete. It goes to Travion Thompson, redshirt freshman from Durham, North Carolina.
Good timing. Good timing pattern. Got the ball, threw it out.
So inside of eight to play. They're short of the first down by a couple. They didn't like the spot. It's at the 34. You're in four down territory anyway. They've got a good thing going on. Momentum. Four consecutive years, Clemson has had at least 10 wins. And spinning, but it looks like
it's
he's going to
be fourth down.
Looks it looks like he's about a foot or two short. It was Zach Brooks, his first carry of the game, the junior from Jonesboro, Arkansas. And as Dabo Sweeney told us yesterday, he may have been one of the biggest surprises in the opening week for them.
Absolutely. Very, very pleasant surprise for him.
He had a foot injury last couple of years. He's been banged up. You see Clemson's record and the momentum this program has. And you know how tough it is to build and stay consistent with a program, coach. And what Dabo has going here now, Coach Sweeney, is an amazing run.
He's put a great plan in place. And, you know, the thing that I like that he's done is you look at his coaching staff, his defensive line coach, Brooks. Robbie Caldwell, his offensive line coach, are really, really experienced guys. And then he's got a bunch of young guys, go-getters on the staff. And so he's put together a great staff. He's got a great plan in place.
And the continuity.
And he's been having some success. The continuity is very important, especially on the staff.
Well, and as he told us yesterday, how fortunate he feels to be at Alabama for so many years and now at Clemson for so many years. Hey,
to be double-digit years any college is pretty good.
Fourth, and you saw less than a yard. Last week, they were two for two in this situation. And Gallman's easily got it. Over the right side. Down to the 30.
Yeah, made the right choice. Last time he didn't go for it on fourth down. There's grumbling, but they intercept the pass and go, and everybody's cheering. Now everybody's happy. We went on fourth down and made it.
Well, you sound like a coach to me.
Former.
That's Coach Tom O'Brien. Young at heart and enjoy and love the Saturdays like all of us. So Deshaun Watson, fresh set of downs. And a ton of time to throw the football. And he throws a jump ball just out of the reach of Pete, who's got the last touchdown. So Sharon Pete.
That was excellent coverage by Mondo Williams. That's what they call a slogo pattern, slant and go pattern. Faked the slant and went deep, and he was in perfect position all the way down the boundary.
Last year, Williams, playing for Iowa Western Junior College, helped to lead them to the Junior College National Championship game.
There you go.
So Watson now 11 of 16 throwing. 104 yards with a score, but also has been picked off. On second and 10, you talked about the timing route and a little stop for Trevion Thompson.
They've got that throw on the flat, and they're taking it every chance they get. And that's death by a thousand cuts. That's what that is.
So they see the cushion on the outside,
right,
high percentage.
Take what the defense is.
I like that. Death by a thousand. Third and less than a yard.
Here we go, corner blitz.
And a huge hole up the middle and a touchdown saving tackle on Gallman. I mean, it looked like if Box doesn't get him, he's gone.
Well, you see Gibbs coming off the corner here. They have a corner blitz. He comes free and just isn't able to make the play.
On first down, bouncing it out. And a flag down where you normally see a hold. Gallman is in. Two flags on the play. It'll come back. First down all over. So at least if you're going to be off schedule, you got three downs.
Yeah, you do. Plus that is, you know, we talked before, they're pounding and starting to wear that defense down. They've been playing a lot of plays out there on defense. Yeah, that's a tackle. That's not a hold. That's a tackle. Elka, you get your hands outside and you take him to the ground like that, you're going to get called that every. In fact, nowadays, you got two officials back there to see that.
Right. And that's the center. Jake Guillermo, the backup center, is in there for Ryan Norton. A little misdirection. There you go on the delay. Gallman up the middle. He's in.
Great play.
Touchdown, Clemson.
Great play on the sprint draw. You're worried about number four getting to the perimeter. Watson and just hands the ball off, and there he is, taking on contact. He doesn't run around anybody. He's going to run right over top of. Very physical, physical guy. 6'1", 215 pounds.
Didn't take long. 9 plays, 64 yards. And Hugel with the extra point. So like last week, long drive, but not a time-consuming drive. Inside of 3 minutes. And all of a sudden, it is 24-0 Clemson. Sophomore Wayne Gallman with a 23-yard touchdown run just before he broke away, giving Clemson a 24-0 lead. And Coach Tom O'Brien, it's basically now 2-1 in snaps, plays for Clemson over Appalachian State.
It is, and it's even worse, first downs. 2 first downs for Appalachian State, 13 for Clemson. Possession time's almost 9 minutes for Appalachian State, 15 minutes for Clemson. So Clemson's going to start wearing them down. They need to get a first down in the worst way here. They're 0 for 5 in third down conversions.
Greg Hugel will kick it away.
Going to give him a chance to return this one.
Man, over to the far side. Appalachian State could return again over to the left side. And bringing it back for Appalachian State. Their wide receiver, Ike Lewis, the sophomore from Simpsonville, South Carolina. So let's see with the good field position once again. And they've had it early in this game but didn't take advantage of it. And they also had it inside the 25 of Clemson. And that was the first interception that Taylor Lamb threw. So he's had 3 picks over the last 4 series. Last time they had it was 3 and out with a punt. And now on a pick play, it's complete. Not much for McElfresh, the former walk-on.
Nice easy pass, get it out there. They got pressure off the edge. And a nice block out there.
Well, it actually turned out to be 7 up to the 45. Can they get points, though?
They're going to pick up the pace a little bit here. Trying to get back in some rhythm.
And it's off the fingertips of McElfresh. So it's almost imperative now that Appalachian State get some points before they go to the locker room. Going up against the defense that was third best of the nation last year and the fewest points allowed. They only give up 17 a game, Clemson.
Now this is a big third down call for them. And, you know, that's a ball that you probably like to have back. You got pressure up the middle by both linebackers.
Can they get 3? Need to go across the 48.
See if Clemson changes their defense.
Yeah, show extra pressure. Lamb overshooting the wide receiver. So, once again, it is 3 and out for the second consecutive time and a punt. And they still can't convert on their third downs.
No, that's above third down and 3. Have a chance to make it. Actually, it was second down and 3. So
way over the head of Alex Gray, the wide receiver. And now, Critcher in to punt it away. Scott will wait back at about the 15 for Clemson. Good one by Critcher. Fair catch. Scott's got it. So Clemson, all of a sudden, and it's coming early. It looks like they're wearing them down a little bit now. Gets it back at their 11.
Plenty of time, 4:55 on the clock. You know, Coach Venables on that last series blitzed all three downs. Went after them all 3 downs. Wanted to establish the fact that, hey, we're not going to let you back in this ball game. We're going to keep our defense aggressive and keep. And what that does is keeps the defensive mind in it.
So Watson and the offense in their deepest field position to start a drive for Dabo Swinney. Inside of 5 to play. And it's starting to become one-sided. As we said, 0 for 6 on third downs for App State. Worst case scenario. As Clemson pounds it. But the App State defense also on the field. Yeah. A long time at the first half. It's starting to mount now. It was Davidson on the carry. We talk about time of possession. You talk about body blows.
Yeah, they've got some backups in there now. Now they got to continue to substitute here.
It's just about 4-1 in total yards offensively. Ton of time again on the out. Scott's got it. Man across the 21. He's got a first down. Going out of the 22. So fresh set of downs. So Appalachian State, they pulled off the miracle back in 2007, beating number 5 Michigan on the road, 34-32. And they had momentum. Don't forget, 7-game winning streak coming in. But the mistakes, you can't do it. 3 consecutive interceptions.
Changing the play.
Grabbed by Pete. Good cover that time by Latrell Gibbs, sophomore, Kennesaw, Georgia. He closed well.
Pitch and catch. That's all they're doing. Pitch and catch.
And is that eventually, if you read it properly, going the other way?
Yeah, could be.
Second. And just a little more than 5. Little counter.
They're a little counter.
Good
great
job.
Great
Boy, you talked about Gilchrist early. He's shown up already.
Yeah, that's an excellent play by him. Folding back underneath and making the tackle.
Stays at home. Honorable mention all Sun Belt last year. He's made some plays.
The good play here is he shuts the big guard pulling out there to block him. Gets out of his way.
So now third
play down. Time. Got to make a play here in Appy State. Showing pressure. Clemson's going to get a change. Appy State looks to their sideline. Appalachian State looks to sideline to get their check. Three-man rush. Man. Throw it right in the hole.
Tight end. Or check that. Wide receiver gets it. Hunter Renfrow. Good hands. Moves the stick. So now they're 5 of 9 on their third down tries. You saw the success of Watson on third down. And it's out to the 33.
What the Mountaineers are doing substitution-wise, they get a ball on the first down on their hash, their substitute. But they don't have to go far, and the chain's got to move. That's how they're getting their guys in and out of the game.
Gallman bounces out. Gets about 7 across the 40, giving them the 41. So plenty of time left for Clemson, of course. Not only do they have all 3 timeouts, but, of course, the clock stops on first down. Boy, would this be demoralizing, though, for Appalachian State? If there's another score on the way to the locker room. Extending the play is Watson.
Trouble.
Yep. He's going deep. And he's got Peak wide open. Touchdown, Clemson. It's 59 yards. Not a bad throw.
No, great play. Extending the play with his legs. He gets out of the pocket, keeps his eyes downfield, and then Peak just keeps running for the touchdown. He keeps running. And one thing you can't do as a secondary is let anybody behind you. And he got behind 2 guys, 2 deep safeties.
It started slowly for Watson and Clemson. Don't forget, it was 3-0 at the end of the first quarter.
Absolutely.
Hugo for the point after. Man. It's been a 28-point second 15 minutes of play for the Tigers. And that drive starting back, as you can see, at their own 11. So they took care of Walford. The concern coming in, and we remind you what we talked about at the top of the telecast, was are they looking ahead? Louisville on Thursday, then after a week off, Notre Dame here in Death Valley.
Well, by the start, you may have thought that. But generally, my experience has been if a team's going to come out flat, it shows up on defense first. It doesn't show up on offense. As I said, on offense, when you're blocking a 3-down line instead of a 4-down line, you've got some adjustments to make. He played 40 snaps, Watson did last week. Maybe didn't get a chance to. He threw 22 balls, so he's got to come back out and throw. But the defense has been outstanding. That tells me that they're ready to play today the way they're playing defense.
And that's a young defense.
Yes.
Boy, does that bode well.
Great tribute to Coach Venables and that defensive staff of his.
Yeah, Brent Venables did a phenomenal job for many years with Bob Stoops at Oklahoma. The same is continuing here at Clemson. So Hugo, in his first activity, he had extra points last week, but he had a field goal early on his third attempt after two penalties on Appalachian State. As they've got Ike Lewis back deep waiting, inside of two to play. And now Clemson's blown it wide open.
Now they're going to sky kick it, try not to give them a chance to return and get down there.
On the return, it's Lewis, and he's got it out to the 32. So give the Clemson defense the credit. Now, even though there's 31 points on the board, as you said, the first 15 minutes of play, and they're playing shutout football to begin with, but the offense didn't get their rhythm at all.
They were in no rhythm, absolutely. And defense picked it up, a couple interceptions, got the crowd back in the game that was kind of sitting on their hands, and now they've got something going to be interesting how we play this. Still coming with pressure.
They want to throw a screen, but it's not there.
That's the same screen that they threw earlier that got him 23 yards in that completion.
There is no foul. There was receiver in the area.
So it stops the clock momentarily. Minute 49 to play. Here's what it boils down to. 58 yards of total offense for Appalachian State on 25 snaps. Incredible work by the Clemson defensive unit. Big back smothered. He thought he was going to be able to get away. Upshaw.
Clemson takes a timeout. They've got two more to go. They're going to have to try to force him to punt the ball. And then I think it'd be good for Clemson. And, you know, people worry about the score and all this, but for them going forward, it'd be great to have a two-minute situation with Watson and their receivers in the line to execute going forward. And,
right.
And I don't think that's running the score up or trying to embarrass somebody at this point. You can get the ball back, play the half the way you would the rest of the half, and try to get better because this is the only chance you're going to get before next Thursday night. And they may need it Thursday night. They may need it a couple weeks against Notre Dame.
Absolutely.
So let's play it. And they're playing it like it's, as they say, they want to play to Clemson's standard. And they don't care whose name's on the jersey they're playing. They want to play to the standard that they want to set. And that's excellent.
And severe tests coming up, as you mentioned. Louisville on the road, and they just took care of Auburn last week. And
well,
then
they didn't
Notre
take care of them, but they
beat
played
them.
What? No, they didn't.
Oh, they lost to
yes,
them.
Yes,
lost
yes,
Auburn.
Yes, yes.
They had the early lead, gave it up. So third and long.
Another pressure look here.
And we're going to get to Notre Dame in a moment.
Three-man rush.
Time underneath. Beathard. And check that. It's McElfresh, and boy, did he take a shot. And I felt it up here. Feel for that young man, Sims McElfresh, who led him in catches last year.
He comes up limping. That's
timeout. Clemson.
That's an injury that App State can't afford.
So it's three and out for the third consecutive time. And also the sixth time in nine possessions for Appalachian State.
Yeah. I hope McElfresh is okay. He does so many good things for Appalachian State. He's going to the bench to check him out. They're going to need him as they go forward with their season.
Tough young man, former walk-on for the Mountaineers. As soon as he caught it, you could feel the jolt up here. And you also talked about something you really can't simulate, practice special team play.
Absolutely.
And another look now with their punt return unit.
Get a chance.
Artavis Scott is going to be going back for Dabo Sweeney. And it's a shame that he's feeling so much pressure. Guy's got to loosen up a little bit. He's tight. Whatever it takes. And it's working right now for Scott, the sophomore from Clearwater. And the Clemson Tigers. Bentley Critcher to punt once again.
Stay onside. Low liner. This is a returnable ball. Great coverage. Excellent job by the cover team.
Very good coverage. So Clemson's got a long field. They also have one timeout remaining with a minute 23 on the clock.
But this is good. I mean, this is better than doing it in practice, I promise you.
Game speed. So Watson has picked up the pace. Second quarter totally different than the first 15 minutes of play for the Tigers from an offensive standpoint. They're going to put the big tight end in the slot next to Thompson. on the short side of the field. Pocket holds up. The underneath his leg at the tight end. Stops the clock at the 28 with a gain of six.
You know, it's 6-7 yards a pop. They can do that, go down the field, still have time to kick a field goal.
Watson now 16 of 21, 192 yards with a couple of scores. Does he want to run? There's a hold. And that's going to be on their big left tackle, the true freshman we talked about. Mitch Hyatt looked like he was holding on. No.
Defense.
Hand in the face.
Penalty.
Yes. And it was against Hyatt, actually,
that's
blocking on
big,
that play.
And he knew it. He was telling his guys, it's on them. Don't look at me.
Watch 75, the left tackle.
That's an efficient pass rush if you're down in the chest.
Nathaniel Norwood, or the defensive end, was called. Moves it all the way to the 48. Minute 13 to play in the half. And again, Watson showing his arm strength a little bit too much, though. Trying to get it to Ray McLeod, who had 8 catches for 80 yards in his true freshman debut last week.
Yeah. He is an excellent, excellent prospect. They really think you're going to see great things of Ray coming in the future here at Clemson.
That's Norwood once again trying to get the pressure. Came a little bit late. Ton of time for Watson. Man, it's deflected. And now we're going to get a flag laid. It looked like it was tipped as he was trying to get it to peak again.
Yeah, that's the back judge calling that all the way from the middle of the field.
Pass interference. Defense. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
So was it legged? Was it peak?
Right now, the officials are conferring down there. So I don't know if this is going to go one way or another.
See, I saw the tip.
Let's see what the...
by Gibbs. Gibbs tipped the ball.
And the back judge can't see this, but the side judges can.
Once it's tipped.
The side judge and the field judge both are down there discussing it with the back judge and the referee. ACC crew been pretty clean today, doing a great job.
They are led by referee Stuart Mullins.
Right.
I thought in live play it looked like it was tipped. And will the play stand or not?
Looks like the...
Yes. Going to go with the call.
Mm-hmm.
So it'll be a first down with 62 seconds left to the 37.
The Appalachian State head coach has called timeout to challenge ruling on the field that the pass was not tipped prior to the defensive pass interference.
Good challenge. It was tipped by the quarterback, Latrell Gibbs.
Well, you have Tom DeJoseph up here, who's a former referee in Sterling Allen, who was a line judge for a long time in the ACC. There are replay officials up here, and they're taking a look at it.
Watch the ball change right there. Should come back. With that said, it'll probably stand now.
You know, and this is a good challenge, because what do? You lose a timeout? You got 3 of them anyway. You can't take them with you the second half. So, might as well take the challenge. At worst, you get a timeout. You get your defense over there. You try to get them organized. You got 1-2 left. Tell them, come on. At worst, we're going to get out of here with a field goal. At best, let's get a turnover. Let's get some excitement going.
Did it change your thinking as a coach on the sideline, though, if it was in the first quarter as opposed to late in the second, and you could lose a timeout?
I think it absolutely does change your play, unless you have eyes upstairs. That's tipped.
And then you always
ask your coaches in the booth, because
right.
they have TV replay,
right.
and you're waiting for them to say, challenge or not challenge. Are you positive? We're sure, coach.
And now they're trying to set the last snap and take the ball back.
Correct.
So the second.
So, you know, generally speaking, when you start writing down like that, that means you're going to take it back to where it was, because you want to make sure you're going to place the ball at the right spot and get the right amount of time on the clock.
Defense, the order of the day for Clemson once again, the number one total defensive team. Yeah, they led the nation last year in overall defense. Third best in scoring defense, giving up only 16.7 a game, and right now pitching a shutout after they gave up 10 to Wofford last week.
After review, the pass was tipped. It will be third down and 9 from the 49-yard line.
Big difference.
Good call, Joel.
Big difference.
You're all over.
Appalachian State.
Well, and
it's
I like to call by Coach
Satterfield.
Right. As you said, what are you doing? I mean, you got three on the board.
You got three on the board. Can't take them with you. Use them.
So give Clemson's defense all the credit. The takeaways, the turnovers, setting up their offense in good field position. And the offense taking advantage of the situation for the second 15 after a sluggish first 15 minutes of play.
The spot will be the 48.
Need to take it inside the 42 of Appalachian State to keep the drive alive.
Is it third and 9 or third and 10? They got it third and 10.
Watson with two on each side.
Good pressure. Twist up the middle.
Yes. Exceptional
Take
play.
A timeout.
Blair got in early, didn't he?
Take a timeout. Good job on the Mountaineers taking a timeout now. Going to make them punt. Let's go after it, right?
Yeah, you know, it's the little wins. You feel for Norwood and Blair guys up front. But as you said, the stunt up front paid off.
Little twist. Got him a little confused.
Norwood really came on at the end of last season. 3.5 sacks over the final four games. Blair got in there, the senior from Greensboro, Georgia. He led App State in sacks last year. And now they stop the clock with 56 seconds left. Let's see if they can do something with one timeout still on the board. And where will they get it? Last thing they want to do is put it up for grabs again deep in their own territory. So field position is going to be, I would think, Tom,
dictate what they're going to do.
Right. Tell Scott Satterfield what he wants to do.
Yeah.
But at least you give your return man a chance. So going back deep, it is going to be Bobo Beathard.
You know, you don't need to see that on the football field with Norwood and Watson. They'll remember that coming out in the second half.
Teasdall with the punt.
He tried to put pressure on it, didn't get it.
No. Fair catch. It'll be back at the 25. So they went for the, instead of setting up for maybe a return, they went for the block.
And I think Appalachian State does the same thing here. Come on out. Let's do a two-minute drill. You're playing against a great defense.
This is going to be, boy, you know you're in trouble when you've got 10 possessions. And 6 of the first 9 have been 3 out with a punt. Marcus Cox had a good job of the secondary. It was Tankersley, the corner, coming off of that block.
Okay, now let's go. Now they're going to go hardball, fastball. Had a chance to get a little bit of gain, get something going. We're going to go out and run the clock out.
Another first down. Maybe and into the secondary. Look out. Cox to the 45, inside the 45. They'll put him out of the 43. Yes.
You got 22 seconds left.
And a timeout. Now you want to set that timeout in case you want to use the middle of the field potentially for a field goal?
Yeah, you would. You want to hold that timeout for a field goal, but I would suspect that what's happened in the past is Clemson's going to heat them up now. They've been playing just base zone. You see them getting in posture to come after the quarterback.
Just the third first down of the game for Appalachian State compared to 18
still
for Clemson.
Play zone.
And look out. The sack for Shaq Lawson.
Now he has to take his timeout.
off the edge and around the left tackle.
Came underneath, great rush. They think he's has a chance to be better than Kurse, who's a first round draft choice going to the Atlanta Falcons. So he's the next great pass rusher here at Clemson University.
He is just a junior from Central South Carolina. He's got three tackles already behind the line today. Three tackles for a loss. It's not bad production. So the timeouts
are
gone.
He's been patient. He's been learning. He's been watching watching the guys in front of him. And now it's his opportunity. And that's a good start for him today with those three tackles for a loss, and he gets himself a sack.
But if they let you use the middle of the field, you still get a stoppage for the movement of the chains. Then you can spike it.
You can.
And you got enough time and at least get three out of it.
But it's second 19, so now you can't throw the ball in the middle of the field and get another playoff and get a field goal if you don't get a first down.
Right. 16 seconds left. Trips on the wide side of the field. And it falls incomplete. Wide receiver was all tangled up. Metters.
Run a corner route trying to get outside the numbers to catch the ball. That was first down yardage there if he would have caught the football.
Lamb with the incompletion now. 5 of 16. Been picked three times with 59 yards in completions. And that'll do it for the half. So the 12th-ranked Clemson Tigers came in. And while their offense stalled early.
Half. Coach Sweeney took a timeout. We're going to make them punt.
Well, right. That's
told interesting. You, we're going to play the first half.
He's going to play.
Clemson, their third final timeout of the half.
You know, it's the second quarter. It's not the fourth quarter. So you just don't stop playing.
Well, as you said, it's also the second game.
Right. It sends a bad signal to your football team. So play the game the way it's supposed to be played, and that's what they're doing. They're coaching as hard as if they were playing Florida State right now. So
you like his style a lot, don't you, Dabo Sweeney?
Absolutely.
We are a long conversation with him yesterday. He lives for this game. He's passionate.
For this game. Great family man. Cares about the kids. And the one thing that, you know, I think he's really proud of is we talked yesterday about graduation.
Right.
All the guys that are graduating and coming back and getting their degrees. And that's the most, you know, we talked yesterday. That's as important as anything else. These kids, you give them a chance to have a future.
Life after. Life
absolutely.
After. And as he said to us yesterday, he's had 120 seniors and 114 have their diplomas. And some of those six are in the NFL right now,
yeah.
Coming back later.
Right.
So it's been a great run. He played at Alabama, an Alabama assistant. Now the Clemson head coach, they've got a good thing going as Cox is going to take it for the last snap, and that'll do it.
And
so they're not going to let him bring it back on a punt.
That's the end of the half.
And, you know, you talk about that. He's got about 10 guys back here, student assistants, getting their degrees of various ages. But Clemson has got a great program going for them, former players that haven't gotten their degree to play the NFL.
So they took care of the turnovers. And we're joined now by the head coach, Dabo Sweeney. Coach Joel Myers upstairs with Coach Tom O'Brien. What did you like the most about your squad in first half?
Can't hear us.
Anybody there?
Coach, you there with us?
Go again, Joel. Okay.
So technical difficulties for us here in Clemson. It's halftime with the Tigers
somebody
on top.
Run.
The shutout of Appalachian State at the break, 31-0. The ACC on ESPN continues from Clemson, South Carolina. And welcome back once again as we get ready for the start of the second half. Clemson all over Appalachian State. End of the first quarter, it was just 3-0. But let's not forget, Clemson looking for a fifth consecutive win. It's pretty tough to find a program with as much momentum right now as Dabo Sweeney's Clemson Tigers.
Yeah, absolutely. Coming off that big bowl victory, and you know, they're doing the same thing again. Shutting out a really good Mountaineer football team that's capable of scoring a lot of points. And, you know, we'll see how he starts off here in the third quarter. I don't think there's going to be any change. You got to come out, play the third quarter just the way you would anytime he's going to do the rest of the season. And then now it's time for Coach Satterfield and the Mountaineers to circle the wagons and get back. And what they have to do is make first downs. Not going to get anything right. done unless they can make first downs. And that has to be whatever calls he has to make is to make first downs, keep the offense on the field for a while.
And we just saw the efficiency of Deshaun Watson, a sensational sophomore quarterback. And we talked about an ACL at the end of last year, but doesn't look like it has limited his mobility at all to start his second season as the starting quarterback for the Clemson Tigers.
No, and he had the one pick, and he was throwing a post. And what happened on that post, the middle linebacker for the Mountaineers got underneath and had to throw it ball in front of him right to where the position where the secondary man was, and they made a great play on that ball. But the linebacker underneath influenced that throw on the interception.
Well, there's big Carlos Watkins. He is going to savor this day the rest of his existence.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure that he's got that ball in his locker right now. Going to ask Coach to get it painted up, and it'll be on his mantle for a long time.
So Appalachian State is going to be kicking it away. Clemson had deferred, took their option to the second half. And it's been kind of gray through the course of the day, but now the skies are clearing over Death Valley. So a ton of possessions in the first half. 10, in fact, for Appalachian State. As Clemson, they haven't had an opportunity to have a kickoff return yet. So now they get the first look, and we talked about how you can't simulate special teams, but they're going to send back T.J. Green with the defensive back and C.J. Fuller. Fuller over to the near side, Green over to the far side. And it is Zach Maddox into it, and did he ever get into it? So that's the way it begins.
That's
in the
exactly
second 30 minutes of play.
Last week, kicked the ball out of the end zone every time, except the one time from the 50s. Guy kicked to give them a chance to make a cover. So
we talked about the efficiency of Deshaun Watson last week. Well, he's already topped that total, at least yardage-wise. He was picked off, though. And that was before the two touchdowns, before things really did settle down for them offensively.
As I said, he got himself in a problem with the linebacker underneath on that. So.
Watson is sending his tight end in motion, but running it the other way with Gallman. And out of an ankle tackle, ooh, could be a late hit, but no flag as he's out of bounds at the 31.
Yeah, same play they ran before that Gilchrist made that great play on. This time they blocked him up a little better. But he's got his hands on his hips. He looks like he's tiring.
Well, let's see if they do run it and also get the clock going. And I'm talking about, well, as soon as I say that, a little pitch and catch. And what a grab. Deion Kane, a true freshman from Tampa. And this was a quarterback in high school. What an athlete.
Well, what they've done is a good job of recruiting athletes and finding positions for them. You know, they've moved guys from wide receiver to defensive back to wide receiver. So they're trying to get the best athletes they have on the field.
From the 39, it'll stay at the 39. Good D. Gallman put down right at the original line of scrimmage.
You know, for the most part, today that the Appalachian State defense is pretty good against the run on first down.
Whoa. And, by the way, it almost looked like it was a delay that maybe they were off the page. Ronald Blair was making no mistake about it.
Well, it looked like they were going to run the same kind of type of draw
right.
that they ran for the touchdown. The sprint draw. And I think Watson was waiting for him to shuffle in to get the ball. And he was waiting for Watson to take the ball to him.
That's two sacks for Blair on his six stops. Ton of time.
All day long, out of the pocket. Going to run for it. Great move.
Short of the first down, he got a great spot. So he's only short by a yard. as opposed to two or three. So fourth down coming, and a decision for Dabo Swinney and Clemson.
They're going to go for it. They're going for it.
So they're going to stay on the field. Saw him convert on the early fourth down try in this game. That was in the first half. Needed a couple of yards and got it easily with Gallman running the football, who's out there right now. They're keeping Deion Kane, a true freshman, in there and spreading the defense, in fact, a little bit.
Trying to draw him offside.
Play clock. As good as their defense is, Coach, I don't blame them. Trying to get them a free first down and then punt.
The same thing happened before. Let them start murmuring. Let the defense intercept and score. Great call. I think, you know, Tony Ellett makes all the calls upstairs, but I asked Coach Swinney yesterday, do you ever overrule him? He goes, sometimes in fourth and one, I'll know what I want to do, and I'll make the call. So I was kind of watching him on the sideline right now to see if he was going to do it, but that's, he wanted to practice the draw him offside play that time.
Delay game again.
Another delay.
Delay of game. Offense.
Now he's not going to be happy with that penalty.
Fourth down.
Yeah, that's after that original delay of game, and that's just not getting his set up and aligned in time. So back-to-back weeks coming up for Coach Swinney. Well, and a short week, and we'll talk about that in just a moment because they're off schedule now. And we're going to get into some of the things he told us because of the way they set up their work week. But that is off because of the Thursday night game right here on ESPN at Louisville.
Well, two of the things that he wanted to be better at this week, they lost the penalty and turnover. They're winning the turnovers, but those two penalties, they're losing the penalty battle right now.
Flag down to the play.
I think we have a face mask. I think we got a face mask.
Tough customer. Grandfather Bobby Beathard, that's Bobo Beathard. His dad also a scout in Carolina.
During the return, illegal block in the back. Number 25, return team. Half the distance, first down.
Call goes against Moore of Appalachian State, and that's how it begins for them in the second half with the football. They'll get it deep in their own territory, down by 31. The Mountaineers and the Tigers, the ACC and the Sun Belt Conference, and all ACC right now, but also one of the best teams in the nation. Clemson Tigers by 31, and welcome back to Death Valley. Appalachian State gets it for the first time, and Taylor Lamb, let's see if it gets a little bit better for this young man in the second 30 minutes of play. Marcus Cox slams it straight ahead. He gets about four out to the nine. Well, Appalachian State, don't forget, they started slow last year. They were 1-5, and they got it going, and they got momentum in the Sun Belt Conference. In fact, six straight wins to close it out. But as you saw the numbers, a serious struggle for the young quarterback. Lane closed in a hurry. Boy, knifing through for Clemson was T.J. Green. You see the closing speed, and you see the reason he's back on kickoffs.
He took a great angle to the football and made a play. You know, that's a great story. That he was a kid that was not heavily recruited in Alabama. Robbie Caldwell came back, I'll get into it later, and told him about it. They ended up offering him. Auburn did the next day, but they got him.
Former wide receiver you're talking about. He moved to the secondary from wide receiver last year.
He was one of those that we talked about before. They're athletes that they kind of move back and forth.
So now third and long on the loss, back to the nine. Pocket hold up well.
Nice throw. Got to catch that football.
In and out of the hands of Beathard. He had a little room on Tankersley, and that's tough for Taylor Lamb. He needs some success.
He needs some success. Someone has to help him make a play. You certainly don't want to be punting from your 9-yard line.
Scott waits back at around the midfield stripe. unfortunately.
Now, one of the things this punt formation does with the four guys spread, they're getting great coverage out of those four guys. And that's been the strength of them punting the ball right now. They're winning the one-on-one matches there on the outside against the Clemson guys.
Short punt. And they'll have it at the 41. So Clemson starting. You would think that they were starting in Appalachian State all day up 31, but this is only the second time that has occurred. And we talked about it off schedule. It's Louisville on ESPN on Thursday night at Louisville. So got to leave on Wednesday. It's a short work week. And coaches are creatures of habit like all of us. And they like their schedule to stay the same.
Well, but one of the things that they did is they spent 3 days in preseason camp spending some time on Louisville, which we'll get into a little bit later, I'm sure.
Watson back out there at quarterback. And going for the deep ball with Artavis Scott, and he's got it. Touchdown, Clemson.
You know, that was excellent coverage down there, and that was just a great play by Scott. But Williams made a great play earlier and good coverage right there. Back shoulder throws, awfully tough to defend against.
You're right, though. He was there every step of the way with him. It's Scott read the ball coming in a lot better than Williams.
Excellent ball skills.
Trying to make it 38 on the board. And Ugel does exactly that. So the second half begins just the way the first half ended. Clemson up by 38. Clemson 38-0 Clemson as they get ready to kick it away once again. It's going to get warm in a hurry here. And we had cloud cover all afternoon, and now the clouds have kind of dissipated. Sun is burning through. It is going to be warm. It is going to be muggy. And that's just what Appalachian State needed. It'll be brought back across the 20. With a flag down on the play. And bringing it back for Appalachian State. Malucky Jones, their wide receiver.
During the return, holding number 19, return team. 10-yard penalty. First down.
Special teams penalty. There is no 19 on Appalachian State, so we'll leave it at that. But now, just to build on for your next game, I would think, for Lamb and Appalachian State.
You know, this is a time you got to run your base offense. You got to give your guys a chance. As we talked about before, how crucial it is to make a first down. I'm sure Coach Satterfield's trying everything right now. So I'd go back to basics. First time we've seen that type of motion, and we end up with a penalty. Now two penalties in a row, a penalty on the kickoff, a penalty on the first play. You're going the wrong way. Has to be a frustrating day right now for that Appalachian State coaching staff.
Appalachian State with just 91 yards total offense. Close to 600 yards of offense last week, but they are not at home and they're not playing Howard. 5 minutes gone here in the third quarter. It'll be Upshaw. And most of the penalty yardage back. Just about four on the carry. So trying to find some carryover to build on for their next matchup. The Ring of Honor here at Clemson, South Carolina. Danny Forges went in 2013. They've got so much history here. Steve Fuller, former quarterback. The national championship team with Danny Ford in 1981. From just shy of the 18. Upshaw buried as soon as he touched it. Now check Lawson out in coverage dropping the end.
That was a great read by him on the the slant throw right there, making a play. So talented, so talented. Turned somebody loose over here. Coming off the edge, got rid of the ball, knew he had to get rid of it, but Lawson was right there to make the play. Another big third down play. Third and 10. Here we go.
We talked about that ring of honor. And how about Shaq Lawson, 6'3", 270, a guy that can run as well as he can.
Well, that gives Coach Venables a lot of toys in his pocket to play with.
So now third and long. Oh, for 9 on their third down tries today.
Now we have the third penalty of this drive.
And that's the defense. Taylor Lamb's looking things, trying to read things. And do I change a play? It's a check with me, potentially. Look over at the sideline. All of a sudden, the play clock is gone. The shots he has taken. What a day for Boulware. Shaq Lawson, Watkins with a touchdown. We've seen Goodson make plays like Dodd. And out of the secondary, T.J. Green. Pressure, Boulware, he had to throw it away. And now you start to feel for Taylor Lamb.
Well, you know, you had four-man pressure right there, not a lot of pressure, played some man coverage underneath with two high safeties, and they can't protect Clemson now that they know it's a pass situation. Third and 15 is not where you want to be against Clemson.
Full head of steam for Boulware. Ray-Ray McLeod waiting now, for the kick.
Ray-Ray made a bad decision last week. I like this. Coach Sweeney's given it another chance to get back there and make a play.
He's got a kid with a ton of talent.
Electric guy. Electric play.
And he's got a lane. They get him from behind with a flag down to the play across the 45 at about the 47-yard line. So let's see what the flag is all about.
Last week they played against during the return
holding.
Kicker, and
he tried number 23, to return team, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Tried to make a play that he couldn't make, created a turnover for Wofford. It's nice to see him get a chance there to make a play.
So Clemson's going to have it, but still solid field position. We were talking about the different type of week for Dabo Swinney as change of quarterback now. Not surprised. It is going to be Nick Schuessler taking over at quarterback.
Clemson starting to substitute now. Get some more players on the field.
That was Tyshawn Dye with his first carry of the game. Young man from Elberton, Georgia. So we talked about Watson. Slow start, fast finish. You would have to think he's done for the day. Trying to bounce out. It is Dye once again up to about the 38. Needs about 6 or more now on third down. But they want to stay in that coach, that same tempo, that same rhythm, despite the backups coming in.
Yeah, well, because they may be playing. So they're going to have to play in this rhythm when they come into the football game if the guy in front of them goes down.
5 of 11 on third downs for Clemson. Little twist up front. Ben Schuessler goes down.
Pressure. That's a good series.
And that's behind the line, so it's a sack. Dada was there. And that'll put it down to the 37, so a 3 and out. Clock fortunately moving. Inside of 8 to play in the third. As Bobo Beathard will wait once again for the Teasdall punt. No letdown by Clemson, despite the fact what's on the horizon for them. Unfortunately, after Louisville in the short work week, they get a bye.
Short
and then
kick.
They've got Notre Dame here. Lucky bounce, a good one. Like everything else for Clemson, it went their way on that short punt by Teasdall. So when we come back, it is going to be Appalachian State's ball at their own 24. Stay with us in Death Valley. looking for their first points of the day. We welcome you back to Clemson, South Carolina. Appalachian State with the football. They're deep in their own territory. Joel Myers, Coach Tom O'Brien. And what a setting. What an atmosphere. One of the very best in college football. Taylor Lamb stays in there with Marcus Cox weaving his way out of the backfield. And met smack dab in the middle by Jabir Robinson. Now, here's another true freshman from Leland, North Carolina. So they're not timid. We talked about it if you joined us a little bit late. 27 freshmen or true freshmen in the game last week for Dabo Swinney.
28 this week. Going to play another one. They're still putting pressure on. They blitzed that time on first down.
After the gain of 2 seconds and 8. Good vision. Cox's
first
best
down.
Run of the day. Running
first
with
down.
His head up.
First
finally.
Down.
Finally. It is only the fourth first down of the day for Appalachian State. It has been that much of a struggle. So four first downs, 113 yards of total offense. Not that time. Loss of a yard back at the 40. So already you're seeing the twos and the threes in there. Four. And we just saw Austin Bryant into the game for Clemson. In on that stop. Roderick Byers back up. And underneath tackle on the left side. Cox slams his way into a wall that wouldn't move.
The Clemson hadn't gone to full substitution yet. They're a couple guys here, a couple guys there, getting them in the game, but keeping some of their first choice guys in there.
Yeah, Goodson's still on the field, who's making the calls, isn't he, Coach?
Yes.
So now third and long. Boy, this says so much about the Clemson defense. That's the story of the day. Third and long, Appalachian State. Good throw, good catch, finally. It's Shadon Metters, sophomore from Duncan, South Carolina.
Excellent throw, excellent catch. Good timing.
And to the wide side of the field, Coach.
Shuffles up, steps into the throw, throws it right on the money.
Back-to-back first downs for Appalachian State. We haven't been able to say that today very often. Happened once in the first half. And now here early in the second half. Behind the receiver, that back shoulder catch, but it's out of bounds as he was going for Metters again.
Tried to get him on a double move and was blanketed in coverage.
It is so rare, and I bring this up because, believe it or not, three out of the last 12 games, the Appalachian State Mountaineers have pitched shutouts. But in college football, you very rarely see shutouts. Maybe sometimes in September, but it is that difficult, isn't it, Tom?
It's awful difficult the way people play offense today, all this fast break.
Cox, good job. Third consecutive first down inside the 31.
You know, that motion's a big piece of their offense, which we haven't seen today. We saw it one time down near the last series, and they ended up with a procedure penalty. But now they get it going. It's option football now is what they're playing.
So the drive started back at the Appalachian State 24. This is the second most efficient drive they've had. They had one where they took it inside the 25, but Lamb was picked off in the first half. Cox, and boy, shedding the block and still making the play. Outstanding play by Kevin Dodd, the left end on his back. This is his first year as a starter.
Yeah, they're putting some of their starters back in there now. And just as I say that, they take their leader out on defense, Bulware.
Dump off is dropped. Barrett Burns, the tight end.
That's a play that Rich Rodriguez came up with a couple years ago at Arizona, where it's the dive, and you come off the dive, and you throw the ball in the flat. He was wide open, just couldn't hang on to the ball, but he catches it. You're talking a convertible third down situation.
So now it's third and eight. 1 for 11 on their third downs. And we just saw that conversion. Will the noise be a factor? It's not even allowed by their standards here in Clemson. Underneath, it's complete. Man breaking the tackle. Good move. First down. And it is Alex Grit, make it Ike Lewis, the wide receiver.
This is a good job of getting him out of the pocket. You see the pressure coming from the right side here. He runs away from it. Receiver, we get a good move down there and catches the ball.
Well, four touchdowns, five red zone possessions. Option action. Will they get there? No. As pulling down from behind the running, T.J. Green, the free safety, made the play as he takes care of Alex Gray. Megan Hopkins. Hopkins, the wide receiver, a double number for Appalachian State. Deepest penetration of the day by far.
And twice they ran that option.
Now, the trips on the wide side, did they go away from that side? No, they went that side. They buried Cox right at the original line. It'll be third and goal from the two.
Good spot to be in the middle of the field on this call. So they can use the whole field limited by the boundary one way or another. So, and I think you got to be thinking two plays here.
Absolutely. You're down by 38. Inside of two to play. And Cox lost about two on the play. Back to about the four. Boy, talk about penetration.
That's the third time they ran the option in this series, their style of option.
They're now fourth and goal, looking back for the signal and the play from the sideline. They'll try to pitch a shutout. Here we go. I know we still have 15 more minutes to play, but there's no guarantee that they're going to be this deep in Clemson territory again. First time out of the second half.
This will be a 30-second timeout.
I think this is a good timeout. You know, it's fourth down. You got a chance to score. You're in a game that, you know, you're down 38 to nothing, but it's important that we get a touchdown here. So they want to go over there. They want to make sure that everybody's on the same page and they got a chance. Somehow the ball's got to get to the end zone line. They got to throw it in the end zone, pitch in the end zone, do something.
Well, we talked to Scott Satterfield a couple of days ago, and I brought up to him about moving the launch point. We just saw that by rolling.
Right.
And let's see if they move the quarterback again by design and give him at least some options.
Right. And the thing that's happened is Clemson's been bringing edge pressure, but they've been bringing it when they've been on a hash and bringing it from the field. So, you know, the guessing game now here for Coach Venables is he going to bring it up the middle or is he going to bring it off the edges on what he expects them to do. So this is what you've done during your summer and the springtime is you break down tape, no tendencies, this is the go-to play, this is what we have to defend, and on the other side, this is what we expect on defense. We got to put ourselves in the best matchup positions that we can put ourselves in.
Marcus Cox, a single to the backfield with Taylor Lamb. On fourth and goal, just inside the four. And they're going to get a five-yard mark off.
Play of game. Offense. 5 yards.
Well, that can't happen out of a timeout, Coach.
You know, I was watching Bulwer, too. He was having trouble getting the guys lined up. So, advantage to the Mountaineers there, but you got to get the ball snapped. Now they go for a field goal. Put points on the board.
And their place kicker needs some confidence anyway, Zach Maddox. And I bring that up because of what happened last year. He was hurt game four, but in the Southern Miss game, he missed three 36, 42, and 43 yarders in a 21-20 loss. trying to get on the board from 26 yards away.
Play of game. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Fourth down.
Do it again. So Maddox, before the injury, was just 1 of 5. So you do want it, confidence from your kicker. We just saw that from the place kicker for Clemson in the first half. From Jacksonville, North Carolina. 31 yards out. And he's got it. So finally, Appalachian State is on the board. The drive started, and it was efficient all the way back at their own 24.
They mixed in some runs, had a couple big pass completions, and they end up with points on the board, which they desperately needed now.
While we've got an opportunity, it was interesting when we talked to the head coach, Dabo Swinney, of Clemson, about the short work week, because he's got kind of a schedule, and he's got a name for every day. And Monday's mental as they prepare.
Correct.
Tuesday, Tanoga. That's takeaways, no giveaways, Tanoga. Wednesday is Working Man Wednesday. That's their blue-collar day. Thursday is Team Thursday. Dot the I's, cross the T's. Friday, focus. Visualize what you plan on doing. So focus Friday. Successful Saturday, get the win. And then Sunday is Spiritual Sunday, their day off, usually. Not this coming week, but I like to kind of drill the uniformity of it all for his squad knows what to expect.
Yeah, I think that's very important. And I think if you go to a lot of the great programs, they're going to have their system in place that the players are going to know, if it's this day and this time, I better be here because this is what we're doing. And that's what he's focused on. And that's what he talks about, playing to the Clemson level. We play to a level that is excellence, that we judge as excellence, not what anybody else does.
Ray McLeod, he's got a chance from the two, and he's got a lane over the right side. Look out. This is a serious athlete. Down the sideline, barely bumped out.
Well, he was a running back in high school.
Couldn't tell.
And as Debo said, he used to always run the power. Well, that wasn't the power. That was wide down the boundary. So I think he's an exciting player to Clemson. The Clemson fans are going to get a chance to watch for the next 3 or 4 years. Breaks one tackle, and it's off the races. Good locking up front.
Yeah, on his debut as a Clemson Tiger last week, he had 8 catches, the most ever by a true freshman in a debut here at Clemson.
Yeah, and you know who ran him down? Gilchrist, number 6. He's done a great job for
what
them on defense. He's the guy that ran him down from behind there.
What a classic motor Gilchrist has, the outside backer.
Lined up into the boundary here.
It'll be first and 10 at the 26. Schuessler stays in at quarterback. On the quick out, he's too tall on that throw. Trying to get it to Deion Kane, former high school quarterback from Tampa, Florida. So the second consecutive drive to start in App State territory for Clemson. Already up by 38 in the final minute of the third. Schuessler goes at 6'3", 200 pounds, a junior from Grayson, Georgia. Toss short side. Man on the carry. Tyshawn Dye.
Gilchrist on the tackle.
Hart, you know, when you're down 38 and you play that kind of passion, that kind of motor, that's a big-hearted kid.
You love to see it.
He's not playing the scoreboard.
No.
He's playing snap to snap.
6'2", 200-pound junior. That's a nice-looking outside linebacker. He's playing for a date in the NFL.
Abbeville, South Carolina. Moving the pocket. Schuessler is not going to get there. Needed about 3, almost 4. And they knock him out right at the 20. Now you get your place kicker an opportunity for a little confidence.
This is a good one now. He was on the right hash the first time, going the other way, and he kept moving closer till he got it. Now he's on his left hash. So,
well, Appalachian State had 2 penalties offside to give him a third try after he had missed then blocked out the first 2. So let's see if he's got a fade in his bag.
He's got a change.
That's the end of the third quarter.
Got a change of the hash mark here. So,
and the last thing Hugo needed was about 3 minutes to think about it.
Yeah.
Trying for his second career field goal when we come back. Through 3, 12th-ranked Clemson Tigers. They are looking like the 12th-ranked team in the nation. Start of the fourth quarter, and it's going to be a 37-yard field goal attempt for Greg Hugel. And will it be his second career field goal? On its way, and he blocked it. Pushed it out to the right. So still question marks around the kicking game with the redshirt freshman out of Blackwood, South Carolina. And looking back over the first three quarters of play, well, Deshaun Watson threw for the day. Very efficient despite the interception. And that came in the first 15 minutes of play when they only had 3 points. And then all of a sudden, coach, they found their rhythm.
Had his top two receivers, 10 catches, talking 159, 160 yards, and 3 touchdowns. So that's a positive day for their passing game.
App State gets it. They've got it at their own 20 after the miss. Taylor Lamb hanging in there. Been a rough day. 7 of 24, 94 yards, picked off 3 times. And using the running back on the option as a decoy. And Lamb throughout the day. Coach Tom O'Brien, he's been under pressure. Let's face it.
Yes, he has. But this will be a great learning experience for him. I don't think he'll see a defense like this the rest of the year. Or at least he hope he doesn't.
Yes.
You know, continue to do, you know, it's second down and 2 yards. Now, let's get another first down.
And spinning is Upshaw. Close to the first down mark.
Yep.
In the secondary. A little something extra. That was
big.
Mark Fields, true freshman. They wanted to get in last week, wasn't ready, from Charlotte.
Right, and he's in now. Big third down situation here now. Twice they've gone with the option.
Need a yard. Run Lewis. Set him up. And if Upshaw got it, he barely got it.
It's going to be close. Oh, they give him the first down.
Move the sticks. Now you want to get out here healthy. Period. Both teams.
Absolutely.
The game's already been determined. You're into the final 15 minutes of regulation. And you want to look forward to the entire season with a healthy group.
Yeah, but you can get better. I mean, they have to play to get better, especially the Mountaineers here.
Right. They've been out and gained 353 yards to 180. Upshaw had a big alley over to the right side and into the secondary. Upshaw, they got an angle on him, and he's out of bounds inside the 20. So the running back, Terrence Upshaw, at 5'10", 210 pounds. Now, he missed spring ball. He had a surgery, in fact, due to that injury. So he's just starting to pick up the pace. Longest run of the day for any Mountaineer. That was 52 yards for Upshaw. Cox is back into the lineup. Gain of about 3, maybe 4. From the 17 down to the 13.
Same play they just ran the time before. The outside zone lead blocker.
So a lot to be gained for the Mountaineers in particular over these last 2-3 possessions potentially to build on. As you say, against a really quality opponent. And will they continue and find some success? Move the H-back. Cox with a nifty
very nice
move.
Yeah. Got a first down. This is a really nice move by him. Little juke inside there. Little stutter step and go. And then this is good for the Clemson defense, as we were talking about yesterday. You know, these guys are the backups. They want to be the starters. So Coach Venable is going to go in the film room and say, this is why you're not a starter.
He made the move on the backup middle linebacker, Kendall Joseph. Diving down to the one on first and goal. Good surge once again by Upshaw. Tough runner between the tackles. He's got size. And I'm talking about 210, 215 pounds.
He gets behind his pads here. Low pads, gets him down, ricochets, bounce, keeps going, gets it down tight.
Second and goal. Can they finally get into the end zone?
Big play for the Clemson defense, trying to make a stop here.
Man, on the play fake, the throw and the touchdown to the tight end, Burns. Well, sold the
It gives the Mountaineer crowd that came here, traveled 171 miles down the mountain, chance for a touchdown, chance to kick an extra point.
Good execution on the sell on the play fake, Coach.
Oh, it's excellent. You know, this is all that option style football, same thing. Like, remember it? He went out in the flat and he dropped the football.
Right.
This time he caught the football for a touchdown. Same play.
Point after makes it a 38-10 game. So we talked about building for next week for Appalachian State as Maddox kisses through. Had a nice drive. 80 yards in 8 plays. We continue from Death Valley. A little inside of 11 minutes to play. And a 38-10 lead for the heavily favored Tigers of Clemson. So some of the seconds and thirds. Barrett Burns doesn't care, though. He got a touchdown. And that's the bottom line. Young man who had 22 catches a couple of years ago from Woodstock, Georgia. And they finally got into the end zone. So a little build, a little carryover for next week. It'll be Deion Kane. Waiting back deep. Man, a little short one. And the tight end who picked it up, making the most of it.
Excellent.
Mylan Richard, the redshirt freshman from Savannah, Georgia. Mom and dad both track All-Americans. He kept growing, though. So he's a tight end now.
he's a big boy.
He is large.
That's exciting for him to get a chance to return the ball like that.
So as you mentioned, and it's funny, I want to go over what you said if you're a coach now. There's no guarantees for coaches in college football today. They're going to be around in 5-6 years. So when you get a really spectacular talent now, the mindset's totally changed in using first-year freshmen.
Go ahead and play him.
Why not?
If he can help you win, you're going to need body. In the way that, unfortunately, there's a lot of injuries, and guys are going to have to step and play anyway. You always want to play guys early in the year. What you hate to have happen, especially at the quarterback position,
right,
is being the eighth game of the year and have to win a football game, and your quarterback hadn't taken a snap yet. You haven't been able to get him in a game, the backup.
Right. Ray McLeod had the nice catch and run, and now they get the first down out of C.J. Fuller. Redshirt freshman, easily South Carolina. He helped his high school team to the state playoffs 3 consecutive years here in South Carolina. Now we've got flags on a false start against Clemson. But I like what you said.
False because start. Number 51 offense. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Too often in practice, your first are going to get most of the reps. And then if you can't get guys at least some game speed activity, then you're really in trouble late.
You'll be behind the ball if you can't get him in the game. So, you know, this is nice the way this is works out for Clemson. Their first 2 games get a lot of people in the game. 77 people played last week.
That's crazy, isn't it?
Yes.
That's just wild. Gain of about 2 on the handoff, and now Mylan Richards going to be coming into the game at tight end. The young man just brought it back.
They have 115 on their squad. I said, do you dress them all? He goes, they want to dress, they're going to dress. Are you going to play them? I said, no, we have to redshirt a couple of them.
Well, you can see, we'll get a shot a little bit later of this sideline. And it looks like 115 down there on the cross, picked off, popped into the air by the big man, and then coming down with it for Appalachian State, it is Law, John Law, the junior from Atlanta. He makes all the defensive calls out there, so the first team is still there.
You know, how special is this? How many times do you see defensive down guys, rushers, get to make interceptions?
And Tyson Fernandez says, yeah. I should get half a pick on that.
That's right.
That paw got up there in time.
What a great play. Really happy for that young man. I mean, he's an inside linebacker, but in that defense, he was a rush.
Right. Player. And we saw on the other side, Clemson, says, right, you're alluding to Carlos Watkins, right, with a pick 6.
Right.
He carried that like a bar of gold. And I'm talking about Watkins into the end zone of the first half. Lamb on a pretty play fake. And a hold. They're going to call it on Burns.
Holding, number 85. Offense, 10 yards. First down.
Tight end who caught the touchdown. There was a nice seal over there, wasn't there?
Yeah, he did a nice job, but I guess he was a little too good with his hands. But, you know, they finally got him out of the pocket, had a chance. Everything was off, run, pass, throw. He's got the chance to run the ball and took off and ran it. So.
Yeah, almost surprised they didn't move him a little bit more. And I only say that because just looking at his numbers, he had 500 yards rushing last year with four scores. So obviously a mobile quarterback. And somebody, when I asked a scout about Taylor Lamb, they said, you know, he doesn't do anything exceptional. He does everything really, really well, though, all the little things well.
And he made people miss when you look at him on tape. So he's got a little shiftiness to him, too.
On the carry, it's Josh Boyd, the redshirt freshman. He looked quick. Nice bolt. The first and 20 takes it out to the 46-yard line. So an opportunity to look at some of their youngsters. Boyd, 5'8", 180 pounds. He's a redshirt freshman. Clock moving inside of 9 to play in a game that was determined a long time ago in the second quarter. Flag on the play. So Lamb.
You know, Clemson played that time with 10 guys.
Brought that guy quickly off.
And but he was supposed to be on
right.
Yeah. Coach Brooks grabbed him on the side. Where's he going, young man? Turn around and get back out there. We're playing with 10.
5-yard penalty. Repeat the down.
And they were still offside.
And then they were offside. Yeah, well, I don't need to call it on him.
Yeah, the big guy.
He can't be offside. He was running towards the secondary. Okay, we're going to play him with 11 this week.
Yeah, it's early in the season. We talk about personnel groupings. And then we were at the walkthrough yesterday for Dabo Swinney and the Tigers. And that's why they have walkthroughs, especially to make sure that you're
those
organized.
Those are the kind of things that drive coaches crazy.
It'll be second at about 9. Upshaw. Or check that. It's Boyd instead. Boyd on the carry again. Not much available, though.
But that's their bread and butter run. And to run it consistently against this, you're going to get better and better up front. The running back gets to run the play, gets to use his vision and try to make cuts. So, you know, I like what they're doing here right now. This is a third down. We got to make a third down conversion here. You know, coming into the quarter, we were, 2 of 13 after three quarters.
Right. Right now, 3 for 14 for the game in these situations. Bring an extra rusher, and it's batted right back on Lamb. Good pressure. So they give Huggins the credit.
Yeah. And, you know, he's listed third on the depth chart. Freshman. He gets to play. He's getting valuable experience here. And that's a nice knockdown for him. And now we're going to go for it on fourth down.
Huggins goes at 6'4", true freshman, Orangeburg, South Carolina. And why not? Fourth and 5 from the 45. Option read, and Lamb will get it. And Upshaw is his decoy, didn't he?
Solid run. Had the pitch guy out there, gave him a little juke. That's what I said. He's got some niftiness to him. And, you know, that's going to prove valuable for them as they get into the Southern Sun Belt. They go forward in their schedule.
You're not going to see a lot of teams like Clemson in the Sun Belt.
No offense in Sun Belt.
No. It's just Clemson, one of the best programs in the country. Ball on the ground, and Clemson gets it. Couldn't get it to the running back. So Carter coming up with it out of the secondary. And everything continues to go Clemson's way. Are about to go to 2-0 on the season. frustration for a former Mountaineer player, and I like it because they've got a good guy. We've talked about both head coaches, and both these programs are very stable for many years to come because of Scott Satterfield and that gentleman, and Clemson has really got it going with Dabo Sweeney.
Well, I think, you know, we talk about Scott. He made some changes midway through last year when he was 1-5, maybe because they were 1-5.
Right.
But they were great changes. They won 70 games in a row. This is nothing to be ashamed of coming here and playing against this football team the way they did. Now, I'm sure he's disappointed, they're disappointed, but it's a learning experience. Let's go back, hopefully no bad injury one way or another, and go win the Sun Belt Conference. They get a chance to go to a bowl game this year, which they haven't had a chance to do. So I'm sure that's their goal. They want to be the conference champs, and this will go a long way to making them a much better football team.
Kelly Bryant in there, quarterback, as that carry is C.J. Fuller. So true freshman to redshirt freshman. And we've been told Kelly Bryant is a sensational athlete. A true freshman at 6'3", 215 out of Calhoun Falls, South Carolina. They're Stockton quarterback, aren't they?
Yes, they are. And he's an exciting-looking player here.
Leading right into the stop because the other wide receiver, Ray McLeod, fell down and couldn't carry out the block on the completion to Renfro. Now, as they get ready to punt it away, you and I sat with Dabo Sweeney yesterday talking about the short work week and the change in schedule.
Yeah, well, what they're going to do is they're going to have to practice on Sunday, which they normally don't do. And by NCAA rules, you have to give them a day off. So he's going to have to, first off, make sure he switches his day to Friday when they come back. But they're going to staff meet tomorrow about 12 noon, get themselves ready to go. He's going to bring his seniors in at 3 o'clock for a meeting. 3:15, they'll have a team meeting.
Gibbs will bring it back. I want to get back to that, though. Runs into his own blocker and goes down at about the 11-yard line. That kind of sums up the day. It's a tough one. I want to get back to the schedule, though, when we come back with Coach Tom O'Brien talking about Coach Sweeney and what it's going to be like getting ready for a Thursday road game on ESPN in Louisville. 28-point lead with a little more than five to play. Welcome back, Joel Myers, Coach Tom O'Brien. We were talking about Dabo Sweeney and the short work week. We got into it because they don't want to practice on Sunday, but they'll have to, won't they?
Yeah, they'll have to do it. And what they're going to do is they'll have their team meetings about 3:15, about 5:35. They'll be on the field for walkthroughs. And it's going to be a Monday type of practice for them. So, you know, that comes the mental Monday. They're going to put a game plan in. As we said earlier, they took 3 days in preseason camp to work a little bit on Louisville because they knew of the short week and they knew that this was going to happen. And because of the difference in the offense and the defenses, they have to be ready. Now, they've got a game plan that they've worked on through the out of season. And what they've done is use the Auburn tape, and then they'll take the Houston tape to confirm, right or wrong, what they expect Louisville to be doing come on Thursday night game.
Marcus Cox out on the edge. Good run. All the way to the 38-39. Give him a first down. Appalachian State. Now, fortunately, after the short week, then a bye and a break before Notre Dame.
It is. And once Sunday gets over, Monday they'll practice, and that'll be a Tuesday/Wednesday practice. They won't hit all week, all right? They may put pads on, they may not, depending upon how they feel. And then Tuesday will be a Thursday practice, and then they have to travel on Wednesday and play the game on Thursday night.
They'll get off to Boyd. Man, Boyd hit his own blocker. Saw the head jerk on the blocker over to the right side.
But you can see the difference right now. App State's getting a little bit of movement up front that they didn't get against that first-team defense that was in there. Little push now, creating a little bit of seams and getting to make some first downs for them.
And they picked up some yards because, remember, midway through the third, they were barely over 100 yards offense. Now they've got 292. And granted, Clemson has gotten a lot of the twos and the threes into the game to give them reps for down-the-road purposes.
Correct. You only get better by playing. You don't get better by standing on the sideline watching. So they get in the game.
Yeah, invaluable. So Boyd's coming over to the sideline on third and about three from the 46. You see what I'm talking about with first half, only 88 yards and 3 points. That's against the first team defense of Clemson. It was 31-0 at the half. Knee three. And on the dump off, they won't get it. Down. As soon as he hit the deck on the completion. And it was Hopkins, the wide receiver. All tangled up, the little guy. At 5'8", 160, a freshman. So now on fourth down, clock going, they'll go for it.
Yeah, I think you have to go for
right.
it.
Good experience, despite the setback for Appalachian State. And I like the resilient part of Taylor Lamb. Three straight possessions, three straight picks, and kind of cleaned it up and managed the game.
That's what we talked to him about the opener, though, is that I don't think he was intimidated here. I'm sure he's going to be disappointed with some of his throws, but he's going to learn from him. He's going to get better, and it's going to make him a better player as he goes forward here this season.
That time, way behind his intended target, Malachi Jones. So when we come back with 2:23 to play, Tigers will have it, and they'll have a 2-0 record, up by 28 at home. One of the best atmospheres in all of college football right here in Clemson, South Carolina. We welcome you back once again for the final 2 minutes and 23 seconds. That young lady is ready. And it's Bryant. Not bad. He's got some. He's good. How about the footwork, Coach?
He's an electric type of player. And he can only get better the more he plays. So it's great. They got to play him some last week. It's great he gets to play some this week.
6'3", 215. So he's a true freshman playing behind a sophomore.
And nice by Coach Satterfeld, too. You know, he substituted. They've got their backups playing in the game right now.
Yeah, he's got to come out now.
These kids get a chance to play.
Lost his helmet, took a shot. So they'll look at young Kelly Bryant.
Officials timeout for an injured player.
Helmet popped off. And then basically into the thigh. So are they tend to Kelly Bryant. Hopefully he's okay. We look at our Capital One Cup impact performance for the game. Deshaun Watson with finding Jerron Peak. And that was the short one compared to the deep one that we'll see here.
As we said, that was a nice one, creating time, creating space, and Jerron Peak just kept running and caught the ball deep, and this was just one play, score, and we're going to go rest on the bench the rest of the day, and everybody else is going to come in the game.
So he had 59, 41, and 23-yard touchdown passes. Two to Peak. The last one we saw to Artavis Scott and Deshaun Watson. And don't forget that he played 8 games last year, 5 starts, so he is still getting better by the rep. And good news, Bryant is up. And over to the sideline. Schuessler will come back into the game. He was going to helmet off. He'd have to leave for one snap anyway.
Anyway, now that it's like he's got a little bloody nose now, and they're going to probably go through some concussion protocol with him to make sure he's okay. Probably won't see him the rest of the day.
Minute 46 left. Exchange, not exactly a clean one. Tug of war. Fuller won it. Got it away from the quarterback. 90 seconds to play. And we're looking at a third down at about 6. So Clemson gets ready for Louisville. Thursday night at Louisville. That's a pretty little ballpark they've got.
And those are great fans. So yes. A great atmosphere.
Boy, things have changed. The facilities in Louisville in the last 10 to 15 years. For both football and basketball, and right in and out of the hands of the H-back on that side for Clemson, trying to get it to Jordan Bianchi. So fourth down, and you get an opportunity again. He's missed one. He's made one.
Absolutely. He wanted to give him some chances. We're getting some chances today. Good for him.
In the first half, he had two penalty flags that negated two misses on back-to-back snaps and then finally made it. His first of his career from 39 yards.
We're back on the right hash.
He missed from 37, and that's what this is going to be, 37. He blocked out, for the most part, the misses. Now can he pull it through, and it's a 47-yard attempt. On its way, a nice bend to it. He's got it.
Excellent.
Needed it, didn't he?
Absolutely.
Really, psychologically.
Yes, absolutely.
So that's big going on the road next week with your place kicker. You don't want to have one for three with two other misses that were wiped out because of penalties. So he's 2 of 3.
And Dabo was the first one out to congratulate him.
Not surprising.
No.
61 seconds left in a 41-10 game. It'll be 5-0 in the series between these two teams. First time they've played in some time, though. And that's the one thing. And I brought it up long before Kelly Bryant lost his helmet and then got hit. You're right, with a bloody nose protocol for concussions. And you just want to get out of here healthy in a game that has been decided in the second quarter. It was that long ago.
Right. Well, you know, they lost Mike Williams, a great receiver.
Yes.
Maybe for the season. I got to talk to him before the game. And, you know, he has a great attitude about it. He kind of had a collision with the goalpost down here the way we're kicking off. And he doesn't know whether he's going to be able to get back this year or not, but he's taking all his energy now, and he's coaching all these freshmen wide receiver up. So that's what you want to see out of a kid like that. So
the one thing we learned, though, is that's a deep position for them.
And it is, but tough. There's freshmen. There's right. Talent. So
last year, Mike Williams, and it's a neck injury with a fracture, slight fracture in his neck, where he's going to have to rest it. No surgery. It's going to be brought back out of the end zone by Boyd, the running back. Man, he's corralled shy of the 23. But they lose a guy that caught 57 last year with an 18-yard average. That's a big playmaker.
That's a big play. And that's why it's important that Pete got to play the way he did today. They need him to come through, and they're going to need some of these young freshmen to step up, especially as they head into conference play now.
So that kick from Alex Spence, an opportunity for a young place kicker just to kick off, redshirt freshman, Florence, South Carolina. As he got into the game, you said 77. I bet it's pretty close to 75, 77 once again.
Yeah, another freshman.
Now to run up the clock, Upshaw. Gain of about 3-4. And maybe one more snap for Appalachian State as they'll fall to 1-1 after they shut out Howard last week. But then Howard was down 62-0 into the half today.
Well, you know, college football is going to take a couple weeks to figure out who's any good still. I mean, you know, a couple guys are really, really good. But for the rest of it, because of the matchups, it's going to take some time.
And, Coach O'Brien, it seems like we're watching one of the really, really good teams today. And a balanced team on both sides, Clemson.
Defense did a great job picking up the offense. Offense struggled a little bit early, and the defense made everything work for them.
So it is official now. It is all over in Clemson, South Carolina, as the 12th-ranked Tigers lived up to their building. And that building, boy, losing 8 starters on the defensive side, but playing shutout football most of the day and only giving up 10 for the second consecutive week. That is a real strength for this program.
Yeah, and you're going to go and say, well, our first defense didn't give. We gave up 0. So they had a chance for the other guys to get on the field and play, so it's a great win. And storm in the field.
Yeah, saw two quality coaches they'll get together.
Yes.
And boy, they're right. Lucky at their programs to have these two guys, Coach Satterfield and Coach Sweeney. For Coach Tom O'Brien, I'm Joel Myers. Thank you for joining us at Memorial Stadium in Clemson, South Carolina. Our final score once again, Clemson 41, Appalachian State 10. And to watch this entire game on replay as well as other games on our family of ESPN networks, log on to WatchESPN.com or download the Watch ESPN app. Thanks for watching, everybody. So long. This has been a presentation of ESPN.